Thank you, Chris. The Orange Bowl, an open field where college football's greatest have sparred. Tonight, it's a battlefield.
So much respect for those guys, and they in turn have so much respect for us. So the only way to go out there and talk is to go out there and play.
This game right here means our season for one, and our pride and character.
We had to go through all the trash talking and stuff back in the days when they used to beat us. Now Florida State's the king of the hill.
Our backs are to the wall right now, and then playing at home, I mean, we're just ready.
Definitely our biggest test for us. You know, we're going into a hostile environment down there at the Orange Bowl.
This is the biggest game any sport I've ever played. I want it more than anything in the world right now.
All the prep, all the talk now ends. Tee time. They want respect. They can get it here tonight. The Hurricanes of Miami. Ron Franklin, welcome once again to CFA Primetime here on ESPN. Florida State now beginning to take the field, but the Hurricanes came storming out first. Folks, this is not just another Saturday night in Miami, Florida. This is the Canes and the Noles, and when this happens, this state comes to a standstill and a goodly part of the nation, simply because this one is fun to watch. What's at stake tonight? For Miami, they can't lose. If they do, there's nothing as far as the national picture for them. You heard Frank Costas just a moment ago, the biggest game of his life. What about Florida State? Well, they would love to defend and win again that national championship. But Bobby Bowden told me on Wednesday, I don't know how good we are. This is always our measuring stick. But after 60 minutes of football on Saturday night, he said one of us does not belong in the upper echelon. We'll find out. Mike Godfrey joins me as usual on the telecast. And Mike, what do you look for? Wide open, hully gully, close to the vest. What's it going to be?
Ron, a lot of speed and skill on the field. But to me, the key is who can solve the other's defense. Miami's only given up 118 yards rushing a game to its opponent. Florida State's only given up 77 yards rushing a game to its opponent. Which team can run the football is the first key. Second key is you have to take the pressure off the quarterback. Frank Costa cannot win this football game by himself, nor can Danny Cannell. He needs the running game. And third and most important, special teams. Tonight, I expect a kick to be blocked, a shank kick, a long run back. Something in the kicking game will set the tempo for this game.
80,000 strong, and as you can hear, they are whooping it up. Mike Adamley is down on the field, and if he can hear us, let's go to him. Mike?
I can hear you, Ron, but just barely. And as you mentioned, Frank Costa is a man on a mission. Last year, he was benched following the 28-10 loss to the Seminoles. Part of his undoing, this fourth quarter interception that Devin Bush returned for a touchdown. For Costa, carrying on the legacy of quarterback U has been more curse than blessing. After the shocking streak-breaking loss to Washington, his play was again the subject of great debate and, yes, criticism. Bobby Bowden has said that quarterbacks are measured by how they play in this game. Frank knows that better than anybody. He has been waiting 364 days for this moment. His chance for redemption just minutes away. Gentlemen.
And now the battle is about to begin. They open the doors this afternoon at 5 o'clock. These kids in the student sections have been standing and cheering like this for that long. This man right here, he'd like to quelch some of those cheers. If you see his numbers, 82% against all others, but 33% against the Miami Hurricane. And what about Dennis Erickson? He's won three of the last four meetings against Florida State. He would like for this house to continue to be as noisy and as raucous as it has been for the past 2.5 hours since the students arrived here tonight. Jamie German, the sophomore out of Fort Myers, looking down at Scott Bentley, the sophomore from Aurora, Colorado, who will kick it off. The 1994 meeting between the Canes and the Noles is underway. Short. It's going to come down to Germany at the four. They'll take it out to the 32-yard line. Now the starting lineups brought to you by Russell Athletic. For the Miami Hurricanes, Frank Costa, quarterback, he says it's the biggest game of his life. And quite frankly, he'll have to play like that tonight for them to win. The wide receivers, this is an excellent group. Chris T is one of the Jones boys, and he's the go-to receiver. The offensive line, a huge group up front, but the smallest is the best of them all, and that's the center, Casey Jones, and he's only a sophomore. Stewart, the lone setback, but it's a play action, and they throw it complete out to German. But he's going to take it close to the first down. In fact, he'll have it. And let's take a look at the starters on defense for Florida State. The defense lost two starters last week. Pennell Spain replaces Enzo Armella at that tackle spot, and he's only a sophomore. We'll keep an eye on that tonight. Great group at linebacker. Number 44, Darryl Bush, gets very little attention, but the sophomore is the second leading tackler on this Florida State team. And in the defensive secondary, Sean Hamlett replaces Steve Gilmer, who's lost for the season. It is his first start. He, too, is only a sophomore. See Florida State coming with the blitz, and they catch him in it, and it goes for another 10 yards. Ball is loose, and who is recovered? At the 48-yard line, Corey Fuller took his feet out from under him. Florida State football. So, Mike, we haven't played 1 minute of football. And the thing that you have talked about over the last couple of days is mistakes, and they can't be made.
You can't make mistakes, but the running game, James Stewart was open for a good gain to the left side. He gets hit, spun around, and drops the football. Corey Fuller, number four, coming back from a knee injury with Darryl Bush causing the fumble.
James Stewart, very disappointed, obviously, the junior out of Vero Beach coming to the sideline after coughing up the football. But on the other side of the field, Corey Fuller is extremely excited about what has happened as the defensive unit sits and gets a welcome break.
They're going to let him snap the ball with Miami not even on the field.
And they do. And they go with the reverse. Kez McCorvey, and it won't go for much. So let's check the starters. This is the way they'll go on offense for Florida State tonight. The running back's Warwick Dunn. He's a big game, big play kind of guy. They'll need him to do that tonight. The wide receiver, Kez McCorvey. You saw him just now. He got to start against North Carolina. His ankle is now just about 100%, as is his separated shoulder. And Patrick McNeil returns at tight guard after that four-game suspension, and they need his experience. He's a senior.
Ron, the most important thing for both coaches right now is to settle their football team down. Miami got out a little bit late for the snap of the ball on that play. They were huddled with the coach on the sideline, but both teams ready to go. You want to spend it as early as you possibly can.
I guess not overly surprising that Bobby Bowden would open with a reverse. Nothing. Absolutely nothing is that entire front. Led by Warren Sapp, number 76. He is one of the finalists for the Vince Lombardi Award. He occupies a defensive tackle spot. The linebacker's Twan Russell. Not a household name, but he's only a sophomore. Watch him also on special teams tonight. And the defensive secondary, typical tough group. They're led by Carlos Jones. He will always play to the open side of the field. He's their best cover man. Canell, first throw, lobs it, got him wide open at the 34-yard line, E.G. Green.
Ron, I like Danny Canell as a quarterback. He's very accurate. Good play fake here. You're going to see from behind Danny Canell. Look at him hide the football. Good fake to Warwick Dunn. E.G. Green coming across the middle right behind the linebackers where they took the fake to the run.
18 yards on that pass play.
now joined by Tiger McMillan. He fakes the run, and he's looking at Kez McCorvey inside the 20. Somebody had blown a coverage as Ray Lewis was close, but Knight, he was not close enough.
What made this play again, Ron, was Danny Cannell's ball handling. Kez McCorvey over the middle again, but what Danny Cannell is able to do on two plays is to fake the football and hold the linebackers. Look at the fake here to Warwick Dunn. Everybody bites on the fake inside. Now he's outside buying time for the completion to Kez McCorvey.
Again, play action. Ball is tipped and incomplete. Kenny Holmes is the man who tipped it.
Ron, Mark Richt, the offensive coordinator, told me that last year Charlie Ward got hurt against Maryland, and it was Danny Cannell's time to be the starter. He and John Stark alternated each game as being the second-team quarterback. He said if it would have been John Stark's turn there at Maryland, he might be starting tonight, but because Danny Cannell got to play a little bit more, he got the starting nod over John Stark.
Stark is a great-looking prospect, you're right.
And they have a third quarterback, Thad Busby, who's a very outstanding passer.
Pressure, just has to throw it away. Kenny Holmes again. And Holmes is going over. He not only forced the throw, but he wants a flag for grounding the football.
Kenny Holmes needs to worry about what's going on in his football game and not officiating. He did a nice job of not riding the fake of Danny Cannell in the last play.
Kenny Holmes, 6'4", 240, a sophomore out of Vero Beach, said to be the best of the pass rushers for the Hurricanes. And the reason for that, he has 4'6 speed. Play action again. Zings it. It is intercepted in the end zone. Malcolm Pearson. So there's a timeout on the field. 12 minutes and 57 seconds left in this opening quarter. And we're going to keep it right here as Pinnell with the interception.
Ronnie threw in the double coverage. Nothing was there. Malcolm Pearson had him doubled for the interception.
So we've had a turnover each. The fumble by Miami on the second play. Wide open and Sidon Tucker, who they were extremely glad to get back. He has had a knee problem. He had surgery last year, and they said yesterday that they were going to play him a lot.
Here's the interception on Danny Cannell, the first turnover for Florida State. See the double team right there. Carlos Jones, number 12. Malcolm Pearson, number 38. Had him doubled the whole way. Threw in the coverage.
20 yards on the pass play to Sy'e Tucker, junior out of Oklahoma City. Number 39, Stewart, full head of steam. He gets hit hard as he crosses the 46 by Sean Hammond. Well, in 1993, 21 of 43, 191 yards. He threw a touchdown pass, but Mike, the number out on the right side, that's the thing that he said almost changed his life, because he didn't get another start until Georgia Southern this year. And it was a thing where college took over, and this young man at times really just kind of felt alienated.
He said he's the most criticized athlete in Miami.
Fidel Spain came across, made contact.
Ron, going back to Frank Costa, he said he can't listen to the radio. He says he listens to Odie Station. He said, I've grown to have a thick skin.
Dead ball. Offside.
So that's a first down.
But in a pro city, Ron, your media and your people
They're going to compare the quarterback in Miami to Dan Marino. They're going to compare Dennis Erickson to Don Shula. It's because pro people are used to pro athletes and people who don't make a lot of mistakes and win a lot of games.
Quick looking pass complete, Jonathan Harris. And the senior out of Houston, Texas, makes the grab and goes down. Mike, because of people like Harris, it makes it extremely difficult to cover their alignment.
But what happened on that play, Ron, was they didn't cover Harris, Jonathan Harris, number three. You see, there's nobody on him. He's on the inside receiver. The backer's over here. It's an uncovered receiver rule. When you have somebody uncovered, just raise up and throw him the football. Take the 5-6 yards.
They list him as a tailback, but majority of the times he is in the slot or wing. Running play to Danielle Ferguson. Breaks it open. Down to the 20-yard line. Clifton Abraham makes the stop for Florida State.
I believe the winner in this football game will come from the team that can develop the run in this game, because both defenses have been very stingy against the run. Danielle Ferguson, number one, just fits through there. Brooks, Derrick Brooks, number 10, was there, but the cutback enabled Danielle Ferguson to pick up good yardage.
20 yards on the play.
Rushing yardage allowed, 77 yards. Now, folks, you can't run against them, you can't beat them. And that's what Miami has to do. Same thing on the other side. Miami's defense gives up 118 yards rushing.
Mike, undoubtedly, they said he was down. He took it to the 20. The ball has been marked at the 30-yard line. We'll try to get an explanation from the sideline during the play. Fastest pass, Chris T. Jones. Caught the ball just shy of the 20-yard line, and that's where they'll give him his forward progress. Clifton Abraham with the cover.
Ron, there was a receiver that was held on this play that could have been open for a big play. He's trying to pick up the hold. I think it's on the middle inside receiver. You see him grab his jersey right there? Number 26. Harold Battles really held the jersey, which allowed him to just slow down the receiver.
No score in
Miami.
Just under 10 minutes left to play, opening quarter. Well, Derrick Brooks obviously did not time the blitz well enough. You have to smile because he's embarrassed to death. He did it in front of 80,000 here and millions on national television.
What he's trying to do, Ron, is time it up just perfect. So when that ball snapped, but timing a little bit off.
Everything is timing.
They're trying to make Derrick Brooks, trying to put him in a position tonight to make plays. He's a playmaker. He has to make big plays.
Again, James Stewart is the lone setback. But that's a lateral. Back to Jonathan Harris. Gets by the first man, and he'll take it down to the 11-yard line. Corey Fuller makes the defensive stop.
Florida State trying to confuse the blocking scheme of Miami. Miami, when you have success against Florida State, Mickey Andrews, the defensive coordinator, likes to move his defense around. Now, you see him in a 4-3 defense. Now, as Frank Costa starts to make the call, there's the movement into a different look to try to confuse the blocking scheme of the Miami offensive line.
So the ball at the 11-yard line. Miami had it first. They fumbled on the second play. Florida State drove inside the 15 and threw an interception. And now the Canes driving. Stewart inside the 5 at his first and goal. Miami Hurricane. Wilson on the stop.
What this drive has for Miami is good mix Frank Costa has thrown short passes. James Stewart, a big, powerful running back at 6'3", 245, picking his holes. And the offensive line of Miami has gained control of the defensive line of Florida State here in the early going.
Miami took the play to the 20-yard line. There was an illegal push in the back. That's the reason for the 10-yard loss, and they started it at the 30 following the play. And right now, first and goal. The ball just inside the four. Stewart cracked at the line of scrimmage. There's just not much there as Derek Alexander is the first man to wrap him up.
When you have a one-back offense, there's not a lead blocker for you. And they don't have an H-back going in motion. So your back, really, there's no lead blocker to take on a linebacker. And that becomes tough for one-back offenses down here. You like to bring a second guy in the backfield, Ron, to give you a little lead blocker.
Good point, Michael, as we're about to hit the halfway mark. In fact, we have of this opening quarter.
And you have a lead blocker in there.
The pitch goes to Stewart, and he will walk it in. Point for the Kings. Mike Crissy, the punter for Miami, is the holder, number 13. They put a junior out of Birmingham, 5'11", 2'11". Take a break. 7-11 left in this opening quarter. The Canes 7, the Seminoles nothing. ESPN's presentation of Saturday Night CFA is brought to you by American Honda, who's been making quality automobiles in America for the past 11 years. And by Russell Athletic, for really tough athletic wear that can survive anything. Get Russell Athletic. Get tough. Well, tonight's appearance by the blockbuster video blimp is part of its 1994 nationwide tour on behalf of the Children's Miracle Network. The blimp is promoting Give a Kid a Lift program, sponsored by Blockbuster Video and benefits hospitals for children throughout the United States. Ellison into the near side. As Florida State prepares with the capers also back deep, Dane Pruitt to kick it off for the Miami Hurricane. Tiger McMillan from the three.
Okay, Ron, Miami on the touchdown brought in Derek Harris, number 34, going to move him up to the wing. Now, he's the lead blocker on this play. Shifting him up. Now, let's stop for a second. Now, here's Corey Fuller, number 4. He's going to seal him inside, and we're going to get the touchdown run by James Stewart. Corey Fuller cannot let them get outside like that, but that's bringing in a lead blocker. Block for James Stewart, touchdown.
The ball is tipped. That thing is alive, and it falls harmlessly at the 2-yard line. The numbers on Costa that drive, 5 of 5, 51 yards. He played that opening sequence like it was the most important thing in his life.
Well, he has a score to settle in his mind. But, you know, sometimes they always say he can't win the big game. And I guess they say the big games are the one you lose all the time, because he did beat Colorado out of Colorado last year. That's a big game.
Short game. Ray Lewis is there to step up and make the hit after a gain of a couple. Lewis, a sophomore out of Lakeland, Florida.
Warwick Dunn, a little running back with a lot of moves. They've got to find a way to get him loose.
And Mike, when you look at what he has done in big games for them, normally he finds a way to get loose. Third down. They need the 26. There's the screen pass. Gets a good block on the far sideline by Zach Crockett, and they will pick up the first down. Burgess finally made the stop.
Ron, Warren Sapp almost made a great football play. He was rushing in as far as a defensive lineman and reversed his field and almost makes the play. Watch Warren Sapp. Here's what you got to like about him now. Talk about gearing it up now. There's a block right there. He came from behind Patrick McNeil, number 69, with a block on Warren Sapp.
Joe McNeil back from his four-game suspension. Paying a dividend already. That pass is going to be thrown complete to Cooper.
The pass is complete.
The strategy of Florida State, with their no huddle, with the shotgun, with their passing attack,
right now,
Danny Cannell coming back on the field, is to fatigue the defensive line.
Exactly. So Stark is standing back in the shotgun formation now. As the number ones will get a breather. This unit will be there, we assume, for one play. And he's going to put it up on top. Going for Riley, incomplete inside the 20-yard line.
Ron, they have a lot of faith in John Stark. Mark Rick says we've got to play him more. He really looks good in practice, and I like what they're doing. They bring in John Stark and throw a bomb right off the bat. They're leaving him in the game. They're giving him some play. 19 out of 24, 258, three touchdowns, only one interception. I like the strategy by Florida State and Bobby Bowden.
So Danny Cannell in the group with the Kentucky Derby that time. As Stark stays in the game. Zipped has McCorvey. Ball is loose, incomplete at the 43-yard line.
Ball right on the money. C.J. Richardson, Chad Wilson. Little play action fake. Kez McCorvey on the curl. Ball right in there, but good hits. C.J. Richardson, number 19, really the defensive back that knocked it away.
Sean Liss will come into punt. He had a hip flexor, and because they're trying to baby that a little bit, it turned into a groin pull. Jamie German back in a single safety, and he looks as though he has no injury on this one. German all the way back, retreats inside the 10-yard line. And he will not make it to the 15, and now here comes a late flag. 52 yards on the punt.
57 yards.
We have a block in the back on the receiving team after change of possession. 10-yard penalty, half the distance.
So the Miami Hurricanes will take it over deep in their own territory. As you look at one of the Lombardi finalists, number 76, Warren Sapp, the junior out of Plymouth. So there's a timeout on the field. 5:05 left in the opening quarter. The Canes 7, the Seminoles nothing. Miami leading Florida State 7-0, just over 5 minutes left to play in this opening quarter.
Florida State gives up 77 yards already tonight, 53 yards. 118 Miami, 3 yards tonight.
Movement again, and I don't know what Costa's doing with his cadence, but obviously he is confusing the Florida State defense.
Well, he's confusing them, plus they're really anxious to move. They need to sit in there and relax a little bit more.
Dead ball foul on the defense, offside. On the penalty,
against the Seminoles.
Three times now, Florida State has jumped off sides in this opening quarter, and Mickey Andrews, defensive coordinator, obviously a little concerned about that.
He has number 10, Derrick Brooks, on the sideline, spelling him a little bit here. Hot night.
Jones with a big breaker, gets off the tackle, outside the 30, and is finally pushed out of bounds. And let's check with Mike Tirico.
Ron, Southern Cal is down 13-2 without Rob Johnson. He's out with an ankle injury. Brad Otten leading them back. Screen pass. Rodney Sermons, 31 yards in the locker room in Corvallis. Trojans by 7.
Wishbone of Oregon State giving them a little problem out there.
Our situation here, running and a mixture of running and passing, but particularly good running by the Hurricanes. They've got them off and with a 7-0 lead, and they own the football again with just under 5 to play in this opening quarter. Pressure, and he's going to be sacked.
Brought Henry Crockett, number 45, up inside on a blitz. The middle linebacker. Sack on Frank Costa, and that was really a quick pass, Ron. I mean, that was going to be thrown on time, and just no time, no blocking but at all for Frank Costa on that play.
Back to the 16-yard line, so it's going to be a second down. Close to 16 yards for the first. Gotten Florida State offside again, it would appear, unless somebody on that offensive front moved this time. Mike? See, Boulware is signaling that it's against Miami this time.
Dead ball. Ball stolen on the offense.
Okay. Maybe Mike Adamley can get a closer look for us down on the field, or tell us maybe what they're doing with the cadence, because everybody seems to be a little bit confused over it right now.
Well, I think
now.
A little offense move there. Ron, in the ball game now for Florida State is Renard Wilson, number 55, and Dulac Gourier, number 99. They are the best pass rushers for Florida State. Number 55, Renard Wilson, really attacks the quarterback.
Play this time. Ferguson. And Ferguson, who only weighs 195. He's 6 feet tall. And the sophomore from right here in Miami takes it back to the 25-yard line.
Ron, Derrick Brooks misses another tackle. We're going to see number 10. There's a linebacker right here. He's going to miss another tackle with a chance on the draw. See the wide rush? They can't afford to be players in the draw. Derrick Brooks has to make that play. He cannot overrun that football.
Well, Ferguson has put him into a believable situation as far as picking up the first down. A moment ago, they had second and 20. Now the line to make is just across the 31. Pass over the middle, and they hit him on the foot. Jonathan Harris turns around and protests to the officials. Two, So it is a punting situation. And Mike, something that we need to keep an eye on is Denny Fortney was the long snapper. Now it's Tremaine Mack. He handles it. He's only 6 feet, 200, and he's a freshman.
Ron, I always used to look at the long snappers. When they're only 200 pounds, they can't swell up. You ask them to swell up and take a lot of room. But when you have a 200-pound long snapper, you're going to challenge him. Challenge him inside with three, four people trying to get to the punter.
See if Florida State does try to come after him. Yep, they do. Right up the middle. He's not going to get it away. And Florida State will take it over inside the 15-yard line. Eric Smith.
Ron, you always look for the small, long snappers because there are a lot of good ones, believe me. But they have to snap the football, and those two slot people have to be real big. But Florida State will challenge us. Now, we're behind the punter, and the snap was really not bad. A little high, but you see how they were able to come up. Corey Fuller up inside. No one blocked the Florida State front. So a kicking game mistake. And I felt going into this game there would be a block kick.
So, Mike, we've had three mistakes now. Two by Miami, one by Florida State. Florida State was intercepted. Miami fumbled on the opening drive. And now it's a good thing he didn't try to kick it. That could have been knocked in the end zone.
He made a wise move because he believes in his defense, too. He had no chance to get rid of that football.
Connell back in at quarterback. Gets it away, and Pez McCorvey close to the first down inside the five-yard line. C.J. Richardson is there to make the stop.
Kez McCorvey, Gil Brandt was telling me today when I was talking to him formerly of the Cowboys, he's going to run a corner route. He said, this is Drew Pearson all over again from Dallas. He said, the guy had a great career for us, the Cowboys. This is him, Kez McCorvey, the next Drew Pearson.
First and goal for the Seminoles. At the one, Zach Crockett.
Flag, Ron.
Flag has been thrown in the secondary, in the end zone. James Burgess is down at the bottom of that pile.
And another flag. A late flag here. Unless somebody said something to the official here.
Mike, this is the seventh penalty. Illegal participation.
Too many men on the field.
Too many men on the field.
We talk about big plays leading to scores.
Danny Cannell would certainly like to punch this one in after that early error when he threw the ball into double coverage.
Either a quarterback sneak down here, Ron, or Zach Crockett is the guy that they usually like in this situation. Fullback. He scored five touchdowns, I believe, mostly inside here.
Look at this place in all the defense.
Dale Phillips, the referee, explaining illegal participation. The penalty moves it about 1 yard away. Crockett, touchdown, Florida State.
Another flag. Ron, the reason Zach Crockett is so effective around the goal line is on the snap of the ball, he is so quick coming out of that stance. He just takes on the tackler and just bulls over him for the touchdown.
Florida State getting their special teams in order on the field. Scott Bentley trying to tie this one up. And he missed it. Wide right. Unbelievable. So let's take a break. 7-6. Miami. We'll be right back. 7-6. And unbelievably, this man has just missed an extra point. Take a look at what caused all this, Mike.
Okay, Ron, when you have the, let's start it right here. What has to happen? Okay, stop it right here. When you get the snap and you got a small snapper, first of all, he can't leave right away. These two players, 96-53, have to really swell up to take on the block. But watch the center, Tremaine Mack, snap the ball, he takes off. 96 really doesn't swell up inside, and the pressure from Florida State does not allow the kick to get off.
But the key to this ball game could be this play right here. Connell with the hold, and Bentley just slaps his headgear. He can't believe it. It's like when we walked in the Miami Athletic Department yesterday, there was a big sign on the wall that said, wide left is okay too.
I think the goalposts in this series moved.
Boy, if people don't believe that the middle part of this game when you play specific teams can be big, I'm sorry, I really think it can. That's Jamie German, number 7. He's back with Shipman. And Alfred Shipman will catch it 5 yards deep and hold it right there. Well, coming up next Saturday, this is what you can see. 6:30 Eastern time of the Southeastern Conference. It's Alabama, the number 10 ranked team in the nation, taking on Tennessee. And then at 9:30, we'll head out west. A big one in the Big 8 Conference, Oklahoma. They were upset today by Texas against number 5, Colorado. So, next Saturday night, Southeastern Conference, Alabama, Tennessee, and then to the Big 8, Oklahoma and Colorado, right here on ESPN. Stewart on the draw. Boy, there's nothing there. You could see that offensive front just got shoved back, Mike. And it was Roberson and Roy there to make the tackle.
They were showing pass, and they, when you show pass, you get very high, and the defensive linemen just on a move, inside move. Just stuffed the play before it even got started. It's a game of momentum. You have to settle down. Each team's made some mistakes, taking advantage of the mistakes.
Miami's made two miscues. One of them cost him. Florida State has made a couple. One cost him. And that ball batted down at the line of scrimmage. And it's Roy again. And let's go to Mike Adamley. Mike.
Well, Ron and Mike, you were talking about Miami's snap count and what Frank Costa was doing that was any different. I was literally 10 yards away and couldn't tell, but we were charting his body movements. He wasn't jerking his shoulders. He wasn't snapping his head up and down. So it's got to be voice inflection, and it is clearly part of Miami's game plan tonight. Make them jump off sides. Snap count. Heck of a guy to have in your backfield. He averages 5 yards every single play.
Third down and the line to make is their own 30. Pass the pressure from behind, and he just throws that one away. A little hard to Trent Jones, and now a flag is down at the 16-yard line. And Tyrant Marion is the man who was coming after him strongly.
And that sets up the punting situation, but the wide defensive ends of Florida State forced Frank Costa out of the pocket, and now another punting situation. And Ron, just because you get one, you go after the second one and the third one and the fourth one.
Okay, that was not a flag. It was in fact a beanbag, a marker where his knee touched.
Watch again, this area right in the middle.
And this time Chrissy gets it away. Lazy spiral, and a fair catch is called for at the 49-yard line. 34 yards on the kick, and James Colsey calls for the fair catch. So Florida State trailing 7-6, again with good field position.
Good defensive series, the wide rush of the defensive ends, and we'll look at that the next time that they get the football. But when they get them in a third down situation, Ron, that wide rush really can bother Frank Costa. And if they get a push up inside, it really makes a difference.
Check it. Rock Preston. And he takes it down close to the 35. And as you can see by Rock's reaction, he thought he should have taken it even further.
Here's the pass rush we're talking about, Ron. You see the distance away, and that's a 300-pound tackle. Now, he's beating him. There's another 300-pound tackle. He's beating him. And if you get pressure up inside, Frank Costa has to step up inside now to make the throw. You see how they're forcing him up inside, keeping him out of his rhythm.
Zach Crockett and the fullback will take it close to the 35 on the first down carry. Mike, I guess the other side of that that is so very important is the fact you're doing it with four people. You're not having to dedicate a linebacker, which leaves you seven cover.
Good point, Ron, because when you do get four people and putting pressure on, then the rest of the people can cover. But go back to the first couple series. Miami had some success against that wide rush with the running game. They have to go back and run the football again with James Stewart.
No, this would not be good news if Carlos Jones had to leave for any length of time, because the sophomore out of Marrero, Louisiana, said to be the best cover guy of the cornerbacks for the Hurricane. Canell in the flat to Crockett. That is excellent coverage by Miami, and they'll stop him short of the first down at the 29 as Marvin Davis got out there to make the hit.
Ron had a perfect play on, because Miami has a blitz on. They really blitzed into the screen. You see number 58 with the blitz, Corwin Francis. Zach Crockett blocks him just like he's supposed to. Now heads upfield with the screen. A couple nifty moves and picks up good yardage. These officials are missing the end of the quarter here.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's a good thing there was some confusion, because Miami had 12 men on the field again, but they got him off in time, and that is the end of the first quarter. With our score, Miami 7 and the Seminoles of Florida State 6. Well, if you joined us late, the key play in the first quarter, Mike Gottfried.
Ron, a lot of punt teams do not ask the center to block. So Tremaine snaps the ball, Tremaine Mack, but Larry Jones, number 23, got his attention to the right a little bit. Maybe ought to should have stepped up inside also, and that would have been blocked, and they would have been able to get the kick off. So it doesn't all fall on Tremaine Mack, because a lot of times I never have centers block and snap the football and go get it.
Also, we should report Carlos Jones, who twisted an ankle. They say he's okay. He's back in the ballgame. And he is out wide, working against Ellison, I believe, on this play. Brock Preston gets by a tackler and is going to be necktied by Ray Lewis. Out of bounds.
You like to have quarterbacks that are mechanically really fine-tuned. And Danny Cannell just runs the screen perfect. And again, the whole strategy of this Florida State offense is to wear down Warren Sapp, Pat Riley, Kenny Holmes, Kennard Lang with what they're doing.
Shotgun, and they take the snap quickly. Cannell rolls that pocket and throws it low, incomplete. Mike Adamley, let's check with you again.
Well, Ron and Mike, I think the thing that's so impressive, whether you talk to him or see him play, about Danny Cannell, is his poise. Remember, he did not start playing until he was a junior in high school, but oh, what tutoring. Former Purdue All-American Mike Phipps, his coach at Westminster Academy in Fort Lauderdale, Dan Marino, worked with him on the art of avoiding a sack, stressing quickness, and then how many hours of studying and watching Charlie Ward. Every quarterback should be so lucky, but he's got a lot of poise tonight.
You might say that he studied under three guys that had their doctorates at doing what they did very well. Shotgun on second, they throw the screen. Crockett down the sideline, and he's bumped out of bounds inside the five. It is first and goal, Seminole.
When you run a screen pass, you want to make Warren Sapp think you're blocking him. Here they give him a little brush block, but they're not really blocking Warren Sapp. They're letting him come in. Zach Crockett gets the screen, a couple missed tackles. You see number 76 chasing him, but he's out of the play, and they're wearing down Warren Sapp with this screen pass.
17 yards in the play. At the one, does he get in? Nope, they say the knee went down just short of the goal line, and there was a flag on the near sideline.
They love Zach Crockett, close to the goal line. Quick hitting fullback. We're having a major conference here. Caught him with 12 on the field again, Ron.
Wow. Dennis has got to be saying, what is going on?
I think they gave him a touchdown, too. I never saw a signal for the touchdown. But they have a touchdown. They got to go for two.
So it is a touch. And Florida State will go for two. Pass in the end zone. Got it complete. Messing.
Ron, they've got Miami really reeling right now because defensively they're getting caught with 12 men on the field. They're caught out of position. They're in trouble on defense. Need to regroup.
So let's take a timeout. 14:30 left until halftime. Seminoles 14 and the Hurricanes 7.
You ready?
Yep.
What's this? We're playing on clay.
Right back.
It's mixed doubles.
Oh.
Outdoor court.
Is activewear becoming too specialized for you? Try Discus Athletic. Heavyweight sweats and tees. Just change your clothes once. To Discus Athletic. The way America plays.
They saw an aurora, and you'll be one of the lucky ones who can say that when aurora was ready to go, so were you. See what happens when you demand better. Aurora by Oldsmobile.
ESPN's presentation of Saturday Night CFA is brought to you by Oldsmobile and your local Oldsmobile retailers. And by Sega Sports, makers of college football's national championship, settle it on the field. Mike, let's go back to what happened as you look at the Sapp on the sideline, and his ball club is now down 14-7. I assume that they scored on the play. There was never a signal given.
Well, first of all, Ron, here's one problem. That's the 13th player right there. There's 12 out here that are still on the field. So the 13th player gets off, but the 12, they still have 12 on the field, and they're still going to go with Zach Crockett up inside. Now let's see if he gets in the end zone, because there really was never a hand signal up. Looks close that he's in there. But because of the penalty, I don't believe there was a signal given for the touchdown.
Well, now they obviously... He did score, and now the penalty, Mike, because it was not declined, because it's coming here and it moves it up to the 50-yard line. Bentley says I'm going to take out some frustrations here after missing that extra point and kick this one out of the end zone. Six plays, 49 yards, a minute 55 seconds, and the drive started on the Miami 49-yard line. Crockett with a 2-yard touchdown run.
Ron, you're still only down 7 points. Frank Costa regained this ball club, get them in the huddle, regain what they did in the first couple of drives. They were successful, put the ball in the hands of number 28.
Green pass comes out to Stewart in the flat. And he's going to be hit from behind. He was looking to see where to take his charge, and he got knocked down by Alexander. Sterry came from behind and pushed him out at around the 25-yard line.
Big win by East Carolina today over South Carolina. Ron, I was watching the Georgia highlights come in today. I'm going to tell you something. I'm a believer Eric Zier is the best college football player in the country tonight. Now, I believe he is playing as well as any player on any team.
Every time we've seen him this year, he's done nothing to dispel
and
that.
And a lot of heart. I'm on his bandwagon. I like him. I tell you, I like the fighting in Eric Zier.
Stewart again turns the corner. Yes, he gets the block, and he's going to have the first down across the 30. Todd Riebel, junior from Punta Gorda, makes the tackle.
And that's what they did successfully in the first quarter, ran James Stewart. That slows down the rush of the Florida State defensive line. Just a little toss sweep, turn by Frank Costa to James Stewart. See the good blocking downfield. First down.
Stewart, by the way, is 6'3", 245. So it's not like you're going to go out for a day in the park when you got to come up and tackle him. You better be very sincere about your efforts. Larry Jones is coming to spelling right now. Slip screen. German, and he's going to be wrapped up. That's Devin Bush, who had the big play last year with the pickoff against Miami to turn things.
Ron, what Florida State's trying to do, first down is a down they have to win. They have a goal at Florida State to hold you less than 3 yards on first down. They were successful in that play. Now it's second and long yardage. They're trying to play Miami with six people in the box. Now, if they can play with six people in the box and stop the run, long night for Miami, because it gives them the extra defenders in the pass. But you'll see six people in the box here stopping the run.
Nice to Green. Jateel Green, he's a freshman out of Lake City. Extremely talented. They think he's going to be the next great one here.
Here's what I'm talking about. The six people inside right here have to stop the run for Florida State. Now, if they're successful stopping it against the offensive line, then it's going to be a long night for Miami offensively. Frank Costa with a good throw to the outside. Yatil Green's a good young receiver. He reminds me of the Andre Cooper for Florida State. They're both big play young receivers.
Good numbers on Costa, 70% for 65 yards in his first half. Shows blitz and they stay at home and they swing it out to Jonathan Harris. And Mike Tirico, ye with the natty tie today. What do you have for us?
Well, thank you, sir. Southern Cal coming out of the locker room ahead 7, and Brad Otten is holding himself up quite well, filling in for Rob Johnson. 50-yard catch and run by Keyshawn Johnson. They score three plays later. The Trojans lead by 14. And in the Astrodome, Houston, which has been losing by an average of 30 or so, right now scoreless with A&M.
Mike, that's always been a ball game. If you look at rivalry situations, and the Cougars have always played Texas A&M tough. This running play is going to go absolutely nowhere because James Roberson, number 47, stepped up into the hole, and Stewart said, wait a minute, I'm going down quickly here.
Ron, first down is a down that you've got to make something happen. Now they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 in the box. Now you're at a little bit of a disadvantage with the open side in. James Roberson, number 47, made the tackle. Now they'll go to 6 in the box, bring in the extra DB or move a linebacker out to try to help with the pass.
Daniel Ferguson, number 1, is coming to the lineup. And the reason for the delay is the Miami bench is being asked to step back off the sideline a little bit. Everybody's got, what did you call it, Mike? A get back coach. But this time the officials were doing it.
I think the get back coach is up front watching the action.
This one you ought to be as close to it as you can be. Third down and 6. The line to make is the 46 of Florida State. 14-7, Seminoles lead. see movement on the left side. 73, Ricky Perry started back with that left foot, and Boulware came across the line of scrimmage.
Dead ball, false start on the offense.
See the wide rush there, Ron? That's what Perry's trying to make sure he gets out there a little bit. There's a little movement. But see, he's so anxious to get out and block the outside rush of Peter Boulware, number 58, that he moved too soon.
Got that 6'7", 329 going backwards, and he couldn't get it back and forward. Boulware with pressure again, and that ball is blocked. Knocked down at the line of scrimmage by Derek Alexander. Show it is fourth down. And again, let's keep an eye on the middle of the special team, simply because unless they make a change, it could be a problem all night. Using Tremaine Mack, an undersized deep snapper. There he is, number 24.
Really got to have some big, the slot players, the two slot players and the personal protector really have to do a job inside.
And they're coming up the middle again, and he doesn't get it off. And for the second time tonight, Florida State has stopped Miami from punting, and it is at the 23-yard line. Eric Smith with the recovery again.
Well, when you're successful doing it one time, you're going to see it more and more during this ball game. And don't put all the blame on number 24, Tremaine Mack, because he's the snapper. That's his job, to get the football back there. But what's happening is you see from behind the inside rush. Tremaine snaps the football. No one picks up the inside rusher. Watch coming at the punter. If you're punting the football, there's no way. They have to pick the slot players are the players that are making the mistakes up there.
That was Guerriere. Dulac Guerriere is the man who blocked that attempted punt. And straight ahead, Warwick Dunn. And boy, he really takes a shot after he's hit from the front and then from behind. Pat Riley was the first man there.
Ron, it's such a big play, the punt. But I really believe the mistake is being made by the slot backs. And I'll show you after this play what I'm talking about.
Seven Seminoles on top. Under 10 minutes to play in the opening half. Pass intercepted in the flat. That's C.J. Richardson. And he's trying to get a convoy in front. One man. Can he beat Connell? Connell gets over and helps stop the play.
Ensure that this play does not get blocked. Those three players have to work inside. You see, they just open up the floodgates. Now, Miami defense back up. C.J. Richardson's going to pick off a poorly thrown football to Melvin Pearsall. It's intercepted. C.J. Richardson now turns a field position mistake into Miami favor. Big plays, Ron, already in this ballgame.
Two pickoffs of Danny Cannell passes. Warwick Dunn finally made the tackle. Pass in the flat. That's Corey Fuller with the coverage. Fans wanted a little pass interference. It was complete.
When you play both these teams, Ron, if you're coaching against them or playing against them, people play them real soft in the secondary because they have great speed. But playing against each other, they challenge the receivers. You see, Chris T. Jones, that came off the line of scrimmage. Corey Fuller, he doesn't care about that speed. He's going to try to stay right with him. Jam on the receiver, very important. Corey Fuller coming off a knee injury.
Derek Alexander, you got a good look at the big guy out of Jacksonville. Knowing we had an opportunity, now we got to keep the Hurricanes out of the end zone. And they run right at it. 5 yards, count it up at 6, 7, and 8. Hamlet finally will make the stop on Stewart, but it is a first down for the Hurricanes of Miami.
Ron, the player that makes this play was Jonathan Harris, number three. He's a little guy, only he's 5'9", 170, but he got a block on the linebacker that really sprung the play.
Derek Brooks injured on the play, and it looks like either an ankle or the right knee. That's the foot. The right foot. We'll get a report. First down, Miami. The ball inside the 20-yard line. Draw play. That one was doomed from the get-go. Daniel Ferguson got there a little quick and then got also Florida State very quickly. Derek Brooks. Again, the trainers are right there. It looks like he's going to try to walk it off, but let's see if they try to retape him or put ice on it or exactly what. Maybe just a stinger. Sometimes hurts real bad for a little bit and then it's gone.
One thing about Florida State, they have a lot of depth. With even Derek Brooks out, they still have some pretty good linebackers.
Costa under pressure. Gets by a second person and then throws it and the ball is dropped. Saeed Tucker. Derek Alexander had it. He was dead in his tracks and he got by him. Then got by Tyrant Marion and threw the ball and Tucker dropped it.
Well, what Florida State is trying to do, I'm going to circle Derek. Well, it's going too fast. Derek Alexander is lined up on the outside eye of the guard. That means he's single blocked. Single block Derek Alexander, you're going to make sure you have him blocked.
Well, Brooks is back in the ball game. Obviously, he thinks he's well enough to go. Lobs it over the middle. It is caught. A.C. Tellison, first and goal, Miami. And you could see what happened. Bush went for the interception.
Ron, excellent concentration by A.C. Tellison. Frank Costa with the throw. A.C. Tellison looks this ball right into his hands. You see it's behind him. Devin Bush was going for the interception, but great concentration by A.C. Tellison.
And now a timeout has been called by the Hurricanes. So let's take it with them. 7:33 left until halftime. 14-7, Florida State.
Exhilarating comes into your life at the exact moment you're ready, screamingly ready for it. It's not coincidence. Aurora by Oldsmobile. See what happens when you demand better. Aurora.
Next Saturday at 6:30, Alabama's Crimson Tide roll over the Volunteers of Tennessee. And at 9:30, the Colorado Buffaloes take on Oklahoma.
Sports Riders. Everyone had a pick football's national champion? It's a highly scientific process. It's time to settle it on the field. Introducing college football's national championship by Sega Sports. 32 top college teams going head-to-head. No sports riders, just great football action. College football's national championship, only on Sega Genesis.
Sega!
Florida State by 7, and it's time for the Sega Students of the Game. For Florida State, senior linebacker Derek Brooks, he's majoring in communications, has a 3.3 GPA. And for Miami, senior defensive tackle Dwayne Johnson, he's majoring in general studies and has a 2.8. Sega congratulates these fine student athletes.
Ron, you think you're a James Stewart, 245-pound tailback, first and five, they hammer him right at Florida State.
we will see as three wide receivers come to the bottom of the screen. And that's what they do. Stewart bounces outside, and he'll walk in.
Big plays, Ron. Put an asterisk behind C.J. Richardson's interception because they had a chance to open up the floodgates when he picked that pass off.
Yeah, 21-7 would have been huge. 58 yards on the return by Richardson. And Dane Pruitt trying to tie this ball game. And he does. So we'll take a break. 7:28 left in this opening half. Canes 14, the Seminoles 14. Tied at 14 apiece, and Mike Gottfried, just what you had suggested. And we'll take a look at that in just a moment as you look at the offensive line for the Miami Hurricane. And they, those big tackles particularly, did quite a job. As you can see, the FSU guys sitting in front of that fan and taking a break. Tied at 14. Riley and Tiger McMillan waiting on this Dane Pruitt kickoff. This is McMillan. And McMillan runs into his own man.
Ron, Miami with a good mismatch here. Here's a 300-pound tackle, Ricky Perry, versus a linebacker who's 205. You're going to get a good block out here by Sae Tucker against Derrick Brooks. Now, we'll start the play. Now, watch. Derrick Brooks, stop it right here. Stop it. Derrick Brooks in pretty good shape and now gets hooked. And now James Stewart is able to get outside. And I don't know if he was holding him or what, but he did not get off the block, Derrick Brooks.
£339 comes down on you. It's you're pretty well hooked. Now Connell, with his back to the student section, is having to endure the loudest offensive surge for him tonight, and he throws that one very, very short. Kez McCorvey is who he wanted.
Yeah, Warren Sapp is disrupting this passing game, just roaring up the field. The Miami defense, the 4-3 defense, is predicated on the fact that Pat Riley, Warren Sapp have to get penetration up inside, force the double teams.
They try to send him straight ahead, and Warren Sapp steps right up into the hole and says, nope, that's the end of it. And Kenny Holmes.
Ron, coaches talk about techniques, and now look at what they're doing. They're moving Warren Sapp over here, and he's on the outside eye. That means the center can't help at all blocking him. So it's a single block all the way. Now, the tackle helps, but comes off, and Warren Sapp makes the tackle. So Miami is moving Warren Sapp side to side, trying to get him in the position to be outside of the guard.
Taking a page from the Florida State book because of Derek Alexander and
exactly
all the moves that they've done with him.
Good point.
Near side. It is thrown complete and close to the first down. Wayne Messam, the receiver, and let's see where they put it down. Boy, this one is going to be close, and they're going to ask for the chains from across the way. Hard to tell because they got to come all the way across the field. Mike, I think this would be very, very big as far as Florida State is concerned to take a little of the momentum and the crowd away from Miami because they seem to have garnered more momentum right now than they had earlier.
Are you saying to pick up the first down
yes.
or go for it?
No, to pick up
no,
the first down. I definitely wouldn't go for it.
I know that man's a gambler on that side,
no.
But if you don't make it, you've opened up the gates.
Nope, not suggesting they do that. And they got it.
They don't have to make that decision. Mm-hmm. His stomach feels a lot better, Bobby Bowden.
Seminole, Lisa, 5 yards, first down, 10.
The Warwick Dunn has not done a lot here in the first half. They have not been able to spring him loose in the running game or even to flare him out of the backfield. He has been a non-factor so far in the first half.
We're tied at 14 and about to go under 6 minutes left until halftime. Crockett, and he'll take it out to the 35-yard line. It's going to be a pickup of six. Well, here are Warwick Dunn's career numbers in big games. .67 against Miami on six attempts last year. Now, one thing we need to remind, though, is he did only have 33 yards rushing against Florida, but he also had a pass that went for 73 yards, didn't he? That set up.
He's 3 for 3 tonight. 3 carries, 3 yards. They have to either get him or Rock Preston involved running the football.
Pass hit in the air, blocked and knocked down by Cannell. Very smart move. Mike Tirico, what do you have for us?
Another quarterback looking smart. Freshman Tim Alexander out of the bone for Oregon State that Mike was talking about earlier. A 10-play, 80-yard drive. This guy was fourth on the preseason depth chart. Now he has his team within eight.
Yep, the Ducks trying to play him close.
That wishbone, they'll power it at you. Warren Saffron on that last play with a good deflection. You're right. Good play by Danny Cannell.
Just knock that thing down and get it away from everybody. They need the 39. Throws it complete. Did he have enough? Yes, he does. Pez McCormick. And from where they've spotted it, he's going to have the first down.
Little short route by Kez McCorvey. He knows where the sticks are at. Just a little quick move against the linebacker, Twan Russell, number 45, for the first down.
Mike, he's not the fastest, but he is terribly quick. And they were trying to jam the receivers in practice the other day. And they were really hard-pressed just to get a hand on him. Now he's just going to throw this one away.
I thought it was interesting, Ron, what Gil Brand of the Cowboys, formerly the Cowboys, said. He just reminds him so much of Drew Pearson. And we all know what kind of career Drew Pearson had.
Yep. Here are the numbers on Danny Cannell so far tonight. 10 of 19, 115 yards, and 2 interceptions.
He'd like to have a couple of those back.
One particularly as they were driving in to score in the first quarter, but then the 58-yard return also turned into points. Direct snap. Instead of going to the quarterback, but Miami was ready for that. It's Dwayne Johnson steps up and makes the hit.
All the single wing coaches, the old coaches, are happy to see this play. This is a single wing play. This is a snap to Warwick Dunn up inside. Dwayne Johnson, number 94, makes the play. They say everything comes back in football. Maybe a little single wing.
Everything except the blocking back. Presence in the pocket. He threw it low, but he threw it low wisely. He didn't want to get it picked off, and he also could feel the pressure. He was about to get sacked.
Kennard Lang, number 96, worked him out of the pocket. Danny Cannell stepped up in the pocket, but just didn't feel like he had a lot of time and threw it in the ground. Warren Sapp, quite a player, Ron. Quite a defensive lineman.
Sean Liss is going to be kicking into the breeze this time. 57 yards on his first. This one's going to be shorter. Germany is going to have to run away from it. And Florida State is going to touch this one dead at the 11-yard line. Mike Adamley, it's a 45-yard punt. What do you have for us?
Well, Ron, when Miami lost to Washington, they looked at it, the players did, as more of an aberration than a trend, the beginning of the end of their dynasty. They're not as brash as they used to be, but they're still talking. Team leaders Warren Sapp and Ray Lewis have been most vocal this week, and they had plenty to say about the cover of the Florida State media guide. The Seminoles pictured in victory over the vanquished Canes.
They just showed me that they fear us.
You know, how much fear they have of Miami.
It's a slap in the face, really. If you look on our front page, when we win, you don't see any Florida State.
That's what they do. So we'll take that.
Play action by Costa. Going up on top and throws it complete. Jamie German.
Ron, there's not a lot of love between these two teams. It started a long time ago. But I'll tell you, really deep down, I think there's a lot of respect for both teams. When they get on this field, they know they got to gas it up, fill the tank up, because it's going to take four quarters.
Mike Adamley, back to you.
Well, you know, that's the one thing that has been missing, thank God, from this game. There hasn't been any trash talking, except on the part of the alumni that are sprinkling the sidelines here. They're going crazy.
Do they know how to do that, Mike? Jones, and he's going to be wrapped up by Sam Cowart, the sophomore out of Jacksonville, just across the 30. We're under 4 minutes now until halftime.
Miami doing a nice job, too, of alternating running backs, bringing Larry Jones into the ball game. James Stewart playing a lot. Danielle Ferguson in there at the tailback spot, so trying to keep fresh legs at the tailback position.
Miami has got some really good-looking young wide receivers. They've mixed in with their seniors. Jamie German has been very present, made his presence felt tonight. Also, Green with that one big catch. Draw play again, and Ferguson breaks off a tackle, almost gets by a second. Eric Smith and Devin Bush both got a hand on him, and let's see, I believe he's going to have the first down up at the 38.
They're trying with the wide rush of the defensive ends. You're going to see him go up the field trying to make sure that Frank Costa doesn't have a lot of time to throw. They just turn those wide ends out, and they turn it over to the defensive backs. Devin Bush, number 11, making the tackle. The linebackers have to make the play on the draw.
Jones comes back in with 23. It straight up out at the 44-yard line. And let's check in again with Mike Adamley.
You know, there's such a fraternity among former Hurricane players that it's really quite remarkable. Lamar Thomas was at practice last week. I know Michael Irvin calls somebody every single day. And if you can't watch on television, you come to the game. Alonzo Highsmith, class of
87.
Your greatest moment, your greatest impressions of this series.
I tell you what, Florida State is a team that, if you were Ray Charles, you could see them on the field. I mean, this is a big game for the state of Florida and for the Miami program. So whenever we played each other, it was like two heavyweight fighters just slugging it out, and the guy who could stand up the longest usually won.
You know, one of the things that's been interesting to me, and I think it's a good thing for both squads, the respect is there, and there's no more trash talking. But the alumni, all of you are kind of beside yourself on the sideline. You're still into it.
Oh, yeah, we get into it. You know, we like to come back and cheer for the team because we're all part of it. Guys like Michael Irvin and the guys who can't be here, they're all here in presence, you know. And, you know, we just come down and support the team, man. It's a, you know, we just love to come back and say hello to all the fellas and let them know that we're behind them.
All right, Alonzo, enjoy the game. Thanks for joining us.
So you can see the lateral, and they try to throw the halfback pass unsuccessfully.
Ron, this third down's big because if they don't make it, they've got a punt again. And that's been Florida State's biggest play in the first half, the punt block.
Brooks, and he grabbed him with a face mask. That's going to be a major. Can't be a five-yarder there. Made the tackle with his hands on the face mask.
Talking about earlier, the cadence, he had that one timed perfect. Put his hands on the face mask. You see number 10 sneaking up. Now he has a time now. Jumps, avoids the block of the back. Danielle Ferguson, number one, but hands on the helmet and the face mask. That was a big play because it kept him from punting the football.
I'm really surprised. I'm not questioning the official, but I'm surprised since he tackled him with the face mask that it was not the 15-yard unsportsmanlike variety. In other words, an automatic first down.
Well, they had third and five. Maybe it was 5 1/4 or 5 1/2. You're going to have to measure it.
First down, Ron.
Yep.
Now Miami has to think field goal, score before half.
Clock is running now under 2 minutes until intermission time.
Dennis Erickson has two timeouts left, Ron.
Danielle Ferguson back in the ballgame. He's not the biggest at 6 feet 195, but he certainly has broken a lot of tackles tonight. Boy, he's got a man right here. Just now picked him up. Unattended is Ferguson. Breaks another tackle and pushed out of bounds by Darryl Bush. Inside the 35-yard line.
Go back to the big play here when they had third and five. Derrick Brooks coming over the block of the running back. Ferguson grabs a face mask. And who do you think's the most relieved person in this stadium is? Number 24. That's right. First down. The punch snapper.
Tremaine Mack, who actually is a strong safety.
And that'll be the first thing the Miami coaches do when they enter that locker room is go over that punt protection.
Larry Jones, he's going to be stopped at the 30. Derrick Brooks makes the tackle, and we hit 120 and now 119.
Tackled by Derrick Brooks.
Down, seven, under 30. Pass the far sideline, long throw, and that ball was caught. He posted it with one hand, and then Chris T. Jones brought it down with the other.
What a catch. You're right, Ron. Chris T. Jones really Clifton Abraham kind of gave up on the play. He thought the catch was there. He thought the ball was dropped. Top receiver, Chris T. Jones, 85 on an out route. Frank Costa with a high throw. Wow. Excellent catch by Chris T. Jones.
So they move the chains. The ball is now at the 23-yard line. This is the ninth play of the drive, and they call James Stewart to come back on the field, the 245-pound running back out of Vero Beach. Florida State with the blitz again, and that's where they come with Stewart. Tries to get it outside on the left. 15 at the 10, and they throw him out of bounds, and it'll stop the clock at 35 ticks.
What happens when you get people blitzing inside? If you get the counter play, you can seal them down inside. Mike, James Stewart able to get outside here.
That was, you saw 73 Ricky Perry throw an outstanding block on the play.
6'7", 329 pounds. Now you think touchdown with two timeouts and 35 seconds.
You throw the fade to the wide side of the field.
Fade's got a possibility here. I think you're looking at a throw here right now.
Stewart, two touchdowns.
And look for number seven. He's the guy they like to try to get the ball to on a quick post or a fade.
That's Jamie German, who he's talking about, and now Frank Costa wants a timeout. So we'll take it with him. 35 seconds until halftime, and Miami trying to break out of the tie.
How would you like to join us in the definitive nightmare?
I thought you killed Freddy off.
They told you he was dead.
And since you've been thinking of making it, has anything funny happened?
For 10 years, he's been held captive as Freddy in the Nightmare on Elm Street series.
And now he's got the last laugh.
What is he doing?
He's decided to cross over out of films into our reality.
Cut the effect!
Wes Craven's new nightmare.
Miss me?
Rated R. Starts Friday, October 14th.
Back when we started making tires, most Americans stayed pretty close to home. Well, then the car came along and highways got bigger and better. And in time, people could actually drive from sea to shining sea. And through it all, we made tires for just about any car anybody might use to discover America. Kelly Springfield, America's oldest tire company.
I don't say this to many people,
But the job we do is the most important job I can think of.
Okay, guys, listen up.
I mean, Lewis, there's no such thing as a B-plus mechanic on this airline.
Let's do it. Let's go.
Even the most junior mechanic can keep an airplane in this hangar if there's a hint of a problem. You might think a job like this would become routine, but every now and then, I just take a walk through the terminal. And right there, you see what's important.
35 seconds left until halftime. Florida State 14, Miami 14. And the Canes trying to push it in. Derek Alexander, the defensive unit, well, they have played very well. But a couple of miscues. Miami has 14 points off interceptions tonight.
And Ron, with 35 seconds and one timeout, you can still run the football. They've had success running to the tight end side right here. Tight end side, but also number 7 on the outside. Big play receiver, Jamie German.
Over the middle, and that's what we look for. Jamie German, and Jamie says, wow, I was open, and it was just too tall. I'm only 6 feet. I couldn't get up there.
Ron, he was wide open.
First guy out to the workout.
Jamie German, number 7, comes in motion, and Frank Costa, you're going to see, sees Jamie German wide open, just throws the ball over his head, and the number 45, Henry Crockett, in fairness, flashed in there late.
It's a great-looking shot off that camera on the goalpost. It made you feel like you were a defensive back.
Ron, I think I'd give one play to Stewart here. Got to run it in.
Well, that's what they do. Stewart in the draw play. Hit at the 2, and he'll take it down to the 1 yard line.
Now you got to use your timeout.
Henry Crockett made the stop. Clock still running, and they stop at the 20. Miami calls the timeout.
Now here's the problem you have, Ron, in this situation as a coach. There's only 20 seconds. If you try to run the football in here, you may not get a second play. I mean, you should be able to if everybody gets off the ground and you get your lineman hustle. But you also got the possibility, 3rd and 1, you got to play to throw one and try to get it in, and then you got to play to come back and try to run it in.
And let's check with Mike Adamley.
Ron Franklin, Heisman Trophy winner Gino Toretta certainly knows about the burden of trying to follow the legacy of quarterback Hugh. Your impressions on Frank Costa here in the first half?
He's played well. He's throwing the ball real well. He's mixing up the snap counts. He's got a lot of offside penalties. And, you know, I said it before, the guys are going to win the ball game, and the guys up front and James Stewart running the football hard.
You know, Gino has said that he can't read the newspapers, he can't listen to those talk radio shows. The criticism hasn't been intense, especially after the Washington game. What is it like, the pressure of being a Miami quarterback?
Well, to tell you the truth, I don't think any one of us read the papers or listened to the radio the whole time we were down here. But, you know, especially this game, there's a lot of pressure on you just from the fans, I mean, the coaching staff. I mean, this game puts you in a national championship hunt. And, you know, Frank's played well, and I wish him the best. And hopefully we're playing real well.
Did you talk to him before the game at all? Any words of advice?
I just told him, I said, you just go out there and do what you do. I said, don't worry too much about taking too much of the burden of the game on yourself. I said, you know, just let the boys run the ball and let the guys up front dominate, because as long as you don't turn the ball over in this game, we're looking fine.
Gino, quickly, what about your pro career? Where does it stand right now?
Well, I worked out for Pittsburgh last week, and hopefully something will work out with them in the next couple weeks.
Hey, good luck. We look forward to seeing the NFL down the road.
Okay, Mike, the situation, 20 seconds until halftime. We're tied at 14.
Ryan Collins is in at quarterback, which means some kind of sprint out here, Ron. You got a sprint out quarterback. Try to either run pass option here, I would believe. Try to roll him
now. Florida State saw the change, and they have called a timeout.
Ladies and gentlemen, the University of Miami.
So coming up in the GMAC halftime report, the Irish fall again, Auburn and the streak, and the Heisman watch. That and more coming up on the GMAC halftime report. All of that coming with Mike Tirico on the halftime report.
Ron, Boston College with a big win today. You watched a lot of that game. George Warhop, the offensive line coach, Boston College, a very good game plan by Dan Henning's ball club. Offensive line really controlled, good defense, and a big win for them.
You know, the one thing that I'm happy for Dan and his staff is there were a lot of people who questioned that move when it happened. And when those thousands of kids came running on the field this afternoon, a really good point was made. You know, Dan Henning is a very good football coach. Parcells and some other people recommended him, and they know what kind of background he's got. And obviously, he's doing a good job.
No doubt, Ron. I agree with you wholeheartedly. Now, let's go back to this one. If Ryan Collins stays on the field, and it appears he is. Now, you have 20 seconds, so you think it's going to be a run-pass situation. What I mean by that is roll him to right, the right or left. If he can run the ball in and can get in the end zone, run it in. If he can't, throw it away so I get another play.
12th play of the drive. Throws the pass, Derek Harris with the touchdown. Left until halftime, the Hurricanes go on top 21-14.
Ron, an excellent call by Dennis Erickson, because you got a quarterback that can run, rolling to the right. Now this is a play action pass. If he can run it in, that's the run it in. If he can't, throw it in. If he can't do either, throw it away so we get another play. Derek Harris, number 34, had a key block on an earlier touchdown and a reception now.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the Florida Lottery.
Frank Costa. Yep. And Dennis Erickson, the reaction as they go on top, 21-14. Costa doesn't care how they get it done. He just wants it done.
Well, that's a great way to have your second-team quarterback come in there and help. Mickey Andrews, defensive coordinator, just trying to get Derrick Brooks get organized over there, because they let Ryan Collins get outside. That's the one thing you can't let a sprint-out quarterback do, get outside. Then he does have both options.
12 plays, 89 yards, just over 3 minutes consumed. And look at the balance on that drive. 6-6, run and pass. Dane Pruitt kicks this one away. Ellison will catch it 9 yards deep. Well, coming up at noon tomorrow, Emmitt Smith talks about his nagging injuries on NFL game day. Miami's Brian Cox returns to Buffalo with his lawsuit against the NFL still pending. Then at 7 o'clock, it's the NFL primetime. Join Chris Berman, Robin Roberts, and Tom Jackson for wall-to-wall highlights all tomorrow here on ESPN. Pinnell to Costa. And they got time for maybe a couple of plays. Nope, they're going to go on one knee. Go to the locker room and talk it over. And the clock ticks down. And the Miami Hurricanes. That's the end of the first half with our score. Hurricanes 21 and the Seminoles of Florida State 14. Now let's join Mike Tirico for the halftime report.
Ron, thank
you. 21-14 are scored at halftime. The Miami Hurricanes on top. And, Mike, the question that everybody's asking here in the press box, and I have a feeling America is too, what in the world are the Hurricanes going to do about their punt formation situation?
Well, first of all, they got to get a better snap, but they've got to block it a little bit better. They may even come down a little bit tighter and tight punt the thing and force everything outside and try to kick it quick.
Mike Adamly down on the sideline with Coach Bowden. Mike?
Bobby, first of all, your thoughts on Danny Cannell. Moments of brilliance and then the interceptions.
Yeah, I said before the game, and I meant it, whoever makes the fewest mistakes wins.
both of them have too much ability to allow mistakes. We've made two terrible mistakes. They've capitalized on both of them, and I think we've capitalized on a couple of theirs.
What was the general theme of your talk to the team at halftime?
That they're beating up. We nearly had them on the ropes, and they got off of it. Now we got to get them back on it. It's a 60-minute ball game. It really doesn't mean anything yet. We've got to come back and start fighting. I think we've been pushed around up to this point.
Okay, Coach, best of luck in the second half.
Okay, Mike, thanks very much. Bobby Bowden always very candid and saying that he thought his kids have been pushed around in the first 30 minutes of play for the most part.
Well, I think they have been pushed around, except the two punt mistakes. Miami's kind of dominated the first half. They have run the football successfully. Florida State has not been able to run the football successfully.
From the one. Here are the stats for the first 30 minutes of play.
Ron, when you look at the key stats, Florida State, 12 rushing attempts, only 32 yards. I mean, and compared to Miami, 25 for 96. Miami has more balance, more dimensions than Florida State has had in the first half. Bobby Bowden was right. He had Miami reeling a little bit and left them off the hook.
Team grabbing that stool. Back surgery for Bowden in August, and has to take a break, get the pressure off that thing from time to time. John will take it straight ahead for short yardage. In fact, speaking of him, let's take a look at what he did in that first half.
Well, he has to get the football. Four attempts inside for just 7 yards. Outside, not an attempt yet. But that's the respect for the Miami defense because they run so well. So everything they're trying to do in the running game is right at that speed.
Barely over 2 yards a try for Dunn so far tonight. He's going to be hit by Sapp at the line of scrimmage and knocked down for no gain. In fact, he may have lost a little.
He's having a career night, Warren Sapp. You and I have talked about best defensive lineman in the country. He may be it. Ellis Johnson of Florida is another one. But watch Warren Sapp play off. He made contact, read the block, and then slid to the outside to make the tackle on Zach Crockett. He gets off blocks very rapidly.
Third down. The line to make for Florida State up at the 28-yard line. The 46-yard line, 40 yards in the punt. We'll be right back.
Company sells snorkels, is shocked by high shipping costs, goes to post office, finds parcel post as a smart solution, doesn't cost much, snorkels get delivered. Company keeps its head above water.
Taking a look at the weather, we've got a high-pressure system.
Sitting right here.
And that is bringing us nothing but beautiful, clear skies and old Mr. Sunshine.
Is it just us, or are weathermen really only guessing?
But hold on.
It's gonna get better.
Clear as a bell.
Not a cloud in the sky.
Soaring.
Dry.
That's why we make the Isuzu Trooper. Because life's an adventure. Be prepared.
My prediction, it's gonna rain. Trust me.
Isuzu, practically amazing.
I want to tell you about my home far away. My mother and father are there.
Strengthening the links of communications requires capital. In the last 3 years, Merrill Lynch raised over $50 billion for communications companies around the globe. We connect investors to opportunities and the people of the world to each other. For them, it makes a difference. The difference is Merrill Lynch.
Golf ball distributor gets urgent order. Customer is in Kyoto. She's in L.A. Goes to post office. Finds Express Mail International is a smart solution. Doesn't cost much. Golf balls arrive. By tea time.
ESPN's presentation of Saturday Night CFA is brought to you by Isuzu, makers of incredible four-wheel drives. And by Columbia Sportswear, makers of tough mother jeans and Columbia Interchange System jackets. 21-14 our score as we play in the early moments of this third quarter from the Orange Bowl in Miami, Florida. Mike, maybe a little bit more high scoring than what everybody had thought, but I don't think anybody's disappointed. This is a typical meeting between the Noles and the Kings.
And Ron, number 11, Frank Costa, had a pretty good first half. Kept his offense in control and kept them poised. Maybe that they had some blood on Devin Bush would be the only thing that I can think of here that made him leave the field.
So that is exactly what happened. They had to call a timeout either because of the way that jersey was fit or blood on it. Mike, you're exactly right. Intercepted. Sean Hamlin.
Ron, Jamie German, number 7, ran into the official and got not really knocked down on the play. Maybe it was Harris. Let's take a look at this pattern. A fake and a roll to the right. I believe it's... See the official?
It is. It's Harris.
It's Harris. He ran right into the official and he went down. He was the receiver. So he collided with the official. Sean Hamlin on the interception and field position has changed again.
And Dennis is saying you got to avoid the umpire. So a turnover. And Florida State gets the football right back. And this time just across the 45-yard line. In the flat, and he'll take it close to the first down.
And that was covered very well by James Burgess, number 54. Ball was thrown right in there by Danny Cannell. Again, the screen pass that they had success with in the first half, going back to. Still think somewhere in this ball game, number 28 has to become a bigger factor.
Of an opening, but he will have the first down. Lang grabbed him by the waistline and yanked him down.
Ron, we talked about in the first half of how Florida State moves Derek Alexander around. Well, that is exactly what Miami's doing. Warren Sapp is lining up on both sides, and they exchange him. Usually he's always lined up on the right, but sometimes tonight he's been on the left side.
Well covered and almost intercepted. Chad Wilson had him step for step. In fact, he was measuring the throw as it was arcing. Wayne Messam is who they wanted. And, of course, Wayne is a little bit of a mismatch in size since he's 6'4".
When you look at last week now, as we watch Wayne Messam, number 89. Remember, Florida State had an open date last week. He's working against Chad Wilson. There's two things that happen in open date. One, you get all your injured player back, but your timing sometimes off when you come back the week after.
Gunn slips to the outside, tries to stiff arm, and he couldn't get by Ray Lewis.
Speed, speed, and more speed. There's not a slow player on the football field.
If Dunn is able to get by Lewis, possibly that's when he gives you damage, is when he gets into the secondary and starts to do what he does best.
But even though he's still carrying the football more, he will make things happen if you give him the football.
Got him open. McCarthy at the 20. And he'll take it down to the 11-yard line.
Good fake again. Kez McCormie on the crossing route. Check the linebacker. Ray Lewis, number 52. He's not real sure where the football's at. Gets caught up inside. Kez McCormie just goes behind him. Inside of the defensive backs. Number 19, C.J. Richardson with the play. Again, credit that completion to Danny Cannell's ball handling and the fact that they are concerned about Warren Dunn.
Takes it straight ahead, and he'll go inside the 10, around the 8. Kenny Holmes bangs on it. 21-14, Hurricanes lead. Just under 11 minutes to play now, third quarter.
Pearsall coming into the game. Melvin Pearsall, the coaches, when we had him against North Carolina, said he has the best hands we've ever had on campus. And that's saying a mouthful.
Deacon had him open and he waited. Ellison knows he caught it well out of bounds.
There was either a bust on that play or they decided just to send two receivers out. Looked like he was looking for somebody inside. Carlos Jones, number 12, fell down, but Omar Ellison, number 30, just ran out of real estate.
So it's third down. At the 6-yard line as Warwick Dunn drew worlds of attention as Corwin Francis
trying to get Warwick,
make the hit.
Trying to get Warwick Dunn over here on a little angle pass inside against the linebackers, but too quick a reaction by Corwin Francis.
Also Kenny Holmes came back quickly. So Scott Bendley will attempt the field goal. It'll be placed down at the 24. 13-yard line, a 23-yard attempt, and he's good on the kick. So let's take a break. 21-17, our score. Kane still on top, 9:52 remaining.
Taking a look at the weather, we've got a
high-pressure
system.
Sitting right here.
And that is bringing us
nothing but beautiful,
clear skies and
oh, Mr. Sunshine.
Is it just us, or are weathermen really only guessing?
But hold on.
It's gonna get better.
About.
Not a cloud in the sky.
Soaring.
Try.
That's why we make the Isuzu Trooper. Because life's an adventure. Be prepared.
My prediction, it's gonna rain. Trust me.
Isuzu, practically amazing.
Mother Boyle and son Tim demonstrate their Columbia Parkas radial sleeves. Oh! And zip-out liner. Columbia Interchange System adapts to any outdoor situation.
This is Unisys. This is Konica. What do you expect from Unisys? What Unisys expects from Konica. So, if you know this company, you should know this company. Because Konica has the right solution for Unisys.
This is Dutch Boy. This is Konica. Why you use Dutch Boy? Why Dutch Boy uses Konica. So if you know this company, you should know this company. Because Konica has the right mix for Dutch Boy.
Next Saturday at 6:30, Alabama's Crimson Tide roll over the Volunteers of Tennessee. And at 9:30, the Colorado Buffaloes take on Oklahoma.
Warren Sapp showing what kind of night it is here in Miami. We've got a nice breeze coming out of the south. But it is very, very hot. And these players, we understand that, you know, the intake of liquids on the sideline has been very, very high.
Miami defense have been tested with turnovers and have responded, just allowing the field goal.
Bentley's kick, and this one's going to go out of bounds. And a check-in with Mike Adamley, speaking to the Heat. Mike?
Ron, a word on Devin Bush, who incidentally is going back in the game. The reason why he was pulled from the game at halftime, he was so dehydrated he needed a unit of glucose, and he was also pouring down tons of replacement liquids like Gatorade and the like. Problem was, he couldn't keep it down, so the referee kindly took him out of the ball game.
Okay, Michael. And of course, the officials trying to make sure of the welfare of the kids. And when he was thrown up on the field, that's when they called timeout and said, maybe you ought to go to the sidelines. But obviously, they think he is better now, or he thinks he's better. Mike, I think one of the things we ought to keep an eye on is Sean Hamlett had the interception a moment ago on the collision over the middle. He's a replacement player tonight. Connell Spain, because two starters lost for the season by Florida State in their last game.
Good point.
Is outside, has five, has 10, got it up at 15, and now at 19. And Mike Tirico, what do you have for us?
Ron, we mentioned at halftime, 47 years since Utah's been in the top 25. Mike McCoy, their quarterback, to Curtis Marsh, a 20-yard score at the Murph. The Utes lead by 7.
Well, the Utes jumping out on top, and folks up there are excited about cracking that top 25, I know.
Ron McBride, a former assistant at Arizona, has really brought that program around. Miami usually doesn't throw to the tight end. Sy'e Tucker, number 81, open in that two deep zone down the middle. And you have to credit Frank Costa again with a good fake. Once your running game is established, the play action passing game, even a single back offense, becomes very effective against the linebackers.
Inside the 15, and he's pushed out of bounds. They're going to say at the 8-yard line. Terrell Green, one of those paving the way with a good block.
Counter play. It's going to be a counter play, and we're going to have the pull the backside guard and tackle. Terrell Green with a good block, number 51, and everything that Frank Costa and Dennis Erickson's calling now is working on Florida State defense.
Terrell Green out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, a senior. Stewart to the wide side of the field, and this time Florida State will en masse put a stopper on him. Now, for this kind of running game, this is where this really comes into play, Mike, at 296 and 245 as far as the averages. For line charges against pass plays and what have you, with quickness, as you talked about earlier, it doesn't play as big a part. But down here, when you go nose to nose, it really does, doesn't it?
The big tackles of Perry and Lomelski, number 77, are really opening up some good plays on the power and the zone play and also the counter.
21-17, Miami. 8-10 left in the third. Breaks off a tackle, but will not get by the second, and that is Connell Spain. And a flag has come down on the near sideline. Connell Spain, one of those we're talking about, who's a replacement player.
Derek Brooks really made a great play, Ron. Came underneath the counter play.
This is Stewart, who is down. James Stewart. He's got 16 carries for 97 yards in the ballgame.
Here's James Stewart on the play. Derek Brooks is able to get in and beat the block of the guard. And then the Darryl Bush, number 44, in on the tackle. Connell Spain.
As we mentioned, 97 yards, but he also has two touchdowns. Favoring his left leg, and you see the tap by Clifton Abraham of Florida State, and then another player comes over. That's Sean Hamlin. Yeah, this is a good rivalry, but also, you know what Mike Adamley said off the top, respect is a great thing in this game because a lot of these kids played against or with each other in high school, and that they do respect each other.
There's no doubt. I mean, when you see a good player and performance, you respect that player, and there's a lot of respect tonight for James Stewart.
So from the 20. Following that holding call, the ball is in the air. It's alive, and it'll fall to the turf after Derrick Brooks got a hand on it.
Well, Derrick Brooks is turning up the heat a little bit. He has just made two very good plays. On the counter play, made the tackle, and then he was in on the pass play. And that's what Mickey Andrews, the defensive coordinator, expects out of number 10. Plays that are going to make the difference in the ball game.
So it's third down.
Got to look to Jamie German, number 7. He's your big play receiver.
Steps up and almost picked off by Derrick Brooks. Peter Boulware with the heavy pressure on the play, and Costa went down.
You're right on Boulware, number 58. Derek Alexander, number 90, with pressure. It's a three-man rush. Here comes the fourth man, Boulware, from the outside. Derrick Brooks again, almost with an interception. A little bit too hard thrown for him to pick it off.
Pruitt to attempt the field goal, and this will be placed down at the 27-yard line. A 37-yard attempt. Plenty of distance and accuracy. He gets it. So we'll take a break. Hurricanes 24, the Seminoles 17. Back after this. Well, Derrick Brooks, Mike, knows that he might have kept that 3 points off the board if he was able to hold on to that almost interception a moment ago.
Well, if you're going to be an All-American, you have to raise your level in a game like this, and you play consistent all year, but there's times when you have to make plays. That was nearly impossible for him to pick that play off, but I think what Mickey Andrews and Ronnie Cottrell are telling him is that you have to set the tempo on defense.
The wind. He's been very, very deep with his kicks tonight. Riley's going to return this one. Open the one. Tried to get outside and he couldn't. Carlos Jones. Boy, that speed is. If both of these teams have so much of it. That drive, 7 plays, 45 yards, using up a total of 216. The numbers on Cadell tonight, 153, 2 interceptions. He's 13 and 25. I know the youngster from growing up in this area in Fort Lauderdale would dearly love to put this one back together and put his team back on top.
Ron Rock Preston is in at the tailback spot. He has very good hands as a pass receiver.
Incomplete as the ball kind of hung up there. Pearsall is who he wanted.
Wilson and Farley provided the defense for Miami. Second down and 10.
Greg McMackin, the defensive coordinator for Miami, has really tried to rotate his defense and trying to keep fresh people on the field.
And it looks like Rohan Marley shaken up on the play. He's been trying to play with a stress fracture in his foot. Rock Preston goes down hard at the 20-yard line. C.J. Richardson is there to make the stop.
And when you like to substitute is when the other team is backed up inside their 20-yard line. Warren Sapp is not on the field right now, so this is the time that you can give him a little bit of a breather. Now, if they start to move the ball and get to a 40-yard line, I'm sure Warren Sapp will be back in the football game.
Forrest Conley in the lineup at right tackle, 79. 6'6", 325. Pass is incomplete. Zach Crockett is who the pass was intended for. Okay, Jones came up and made the hit, but he might have gotten a little more than he bargained for when he made the hit, Mike.
Well, hit Crockett. Crockett's 245 on a dead run.
And Jones is 173.
On a dead stop. This is the type of defense that these Miami fans have become accustomed to over the years.
German, the deep man. This is end over end. Calls for the fair catch and makes it at the 43. Well, tomorrow, 4 o'clock Eastern time on ESPN2. Laguna Seca Raceway in Monterey will be the site for Mario Andretti's last IndyCar race of his career. That is at 4 o'clock Eastern time on ESPN2.
University of Miami and Florida State Universities, thank you.
Miami's had great field position. They need to take advantage and deliver the knockout blow. Don't want to let Florida State stay around the whole game here.
Up midway of this third quarter. Crowd has stated this one. Something that Bobby Bowden would like to see curtailed. This running play by Daniel Ferguson will go for maybe one, and that's it. Guerriere comes up to make the hit, number 99.
Wholesale substitutions by Florida State. Six players coming on the field now. After first down, trying to keep fresh people on the field.
And speaking of fresh people, a fourth fullback is they listed, number 32, Alfred Shipman, sophomore out of West Palm Beach, comes in.
Florida State coaches told me they're really concerned about Shipman. He makes things happen.
And go up on top, and that's who he's looking for, Shipman. And the ball, good heavens, hit Devin Bush right in the back of the shoulder pad.
It's a way to use your head off. At least it deflected off of him and went down to the ground. He couldn't find the football at all. He was playing the receiver. You see number 11, Devin Bush has no idea where that football's at. Nor does Al Shipman, number 32.
What Al knows is after it came off the headgear, if he caught it, he could take it in for a touchdown. Mm-hmm. It's still alive. Four to 17, our score. Miami on top. Flag goes down. The pressure is on. Acosta will be sacked. Now let's see if they were drawn offside or not. Because Mike, you talk about a big reprieve. Rather than third and nine, a third and four makes your decision making a lot simpler.
Now, Ron, you're in better position. Now run and pass. It's an excellent screen down here for Miami. They had some success early against Florida State with the screen. Might be a good call here.
So Mickey Andrews knows that his club had the stop just a moment ago, but guilty of the violation. And now third down on the line to make the 47 still of Florida State. Pass Smith throws it complete. That's German right over the middle. And Jamie's going to have the first down at the 46-yard line. And Costa gets up slowly after getting racked after delivering the pass.
Jamie German's the inside receiver. He's just going to go down, let everybody clear out and come inside. Both the receivers on the outside, the receiver on the outside, the receiver on the inside clear out just far enough for the stakes and the first down.
Dennis Erickson, kind of a pained expression on his face. Bobby Bowden continues to pace. And in case you missed the interview with him that Mike had at halftime, he said, I think we got pushed around in that first 30 minutes. Running play here, and this is Larry Jones. Nice job defensively as Darryl Bush steps up to make the hit. And speaking to Mike Adamley, let's check with him again. Mike?
Yeah, Ron, the word on Miami fullback James Stewart, sprained left ankle, sprained left ankle. They expect him back in the game.
Okay.
Second down.
Tough injury and tough to say sometimes. 4.5 minutes remaining, third quarter. Danielle Ferguson, sophomore from right here in Miami. Again, he did. As the flag goes down, Ferguson still on his feet, and he's going to have the first down. They'll decline this penalty, and that is, in fact, what it is.
Danielle Ferguson picked up 10 yards.
Mike, he really has an interesting running style. He can give you lean, or he can give you straight up and give you the quick stutter step.
Gives you the juke. When you get a little tired sometimes, you start jumping offside. Look at the sideline now. Florida State again bringing in six new players. Almost every, you see all the exchange of the defensive players trying to keep them fresh. But again, you look for reasons. Maybe the open gate. When you have an open gate, sometimes you lose the consistency. And they're just not playing well on defense.
Out exactly, although that one was defined, that's at least five times, if not six, that they've been caught in the ball game. Now there's the screen, and Ferguson, not much place. Well, he gets away. Good heavens, could have been for a loss. He's going to take it back to the line of scrimmage.
That's almost the best half yard he's going to gain for a while. Talked about at the beginning, Ron, that some team, one of these two teams, had to establish the run against good rushing defense. Miami has controlled the football, 141 yards rushing against Florida State, and that has offset, big offset, two punt blocks.
Yeah. Well, we got it officially. Five offsides against Florida State. The last one, of course, being declined. Costa has it knocked right back in his face by Roy. Orpheus Roy from here in Miami by way of Jones Community College. 6'4", 275 and a junior. Don't forget, coming up at the end of the game, Mike and I will choose the Visa players of the game, the outstanding players for both clubs. Mickey Andrews looks on from the sideline and hoping that Derek Alexander and the rest of those defensive charges can put a stop on this third down and 10. Costa's going to be sacked back at the 38. That's twice they've gotten him, and Cannell Spain was the first man there.
Excellent coverage downfield. That's what really made the sack. Derek Alexander, number 90, the spin move inside. But see, he keeps working. He never gives up, and then he spins in and makes the tackle on Frank Costa. Great effort by an excellent defensive lineman. Here's the coverage downfield. Pretty good coverage. Good contact down the field by Derek Brooks. The ball's not in the air. Knock him down.
Well, you can see the player go down. Jonathan Harris was knocked into his own player and is gonna need a little attention. 5'9", 170, a senior out of Houston, Texas. And Mike Tirico, while we got a break in the action, let's go to you, sir.
Well, Ron, to start the Fresno State BYU game, looks like Fresno dipped into Bobby Bowden's old playbook. Little reverse, David Duncan throw it to Charlie Jones. First play of the game. Fresno out with a good start, leading the Cougars at home by 7.
So, a little razzle-dazzle there. And, Mike, as we look down on the field, Miami is going to make a change. It is going to be Jeffrey Taylor, who is a linebacker, number 59. And he will handle the snap if that is, in fact, what they do. So Tremaine Mack remains on the sideline. And Tremaine, who is a safety but has been doing the long snaps, probably is just as happy. Well, coming up next Saturday, this is what the schedule looks like. It'll kick off at 6:30 Eastern time from the SEC. Number 10th ranked Alabama will travel to Knoxville, Tennessee, and that's been a great rivalry for a long, long time. Then at 9:30 Eastern time, the Big 8 Conference, Oklahoma against Colorado. So our doubleheader, Alabama, Tennessee, and Oklahoma, Colorado, all next week right here on ESPN.
Tennessee keeps coming back. Another win over Arkansas. Alabama didn't score many points today. People are critical in the state of Alabama that they don't score enough points. But you know what? They're 6-0. And Gene Stallings will take that any day.
You know, in the numbers today, Peyton Manning, 12 of 18, 157 yards and 2 touchdowns. And little man Stewart, 85 yards rushing and 2 touchdowns. And, of course, for Oklahoma, they got surprised today. They were upset by Texas in the War of the Red River, always played in the Cotton Bowl in Dallas.
And Shane Lorenz did not play in that game?
To my understanding, he did not.
A big win for Texas.
Listen to the crowd cheer on the snap, getting back to the punter. Down to the one, and it goes into the end zone. And let's go down to Mike Adamly.
Well, Ron and Mike, one player that Florida State's really misses tonight defensively is back in Tallahassee recovering from knee surgery. But Enzo Armella is here in spirit. Enzo, of course, was lost for the season in the North Carolina game. But as he left on the stretcher, he gave the thumbs up sign, the tomahawk chop, got a standing ovation. This was to have been his homecoming. He went to Miami Springs High School. But his Seminole teammates wanted Enzo to know that they're thinking of him. As a matter of fact, equipment man Jimmy Campbell is wearing Enzo's number 75. And all the players, or at least many of the Seminole players, have number 75 on their wristbands.
So through the end zone, touchback, no flag on the play. To 17 our score with 2:23 left in the third quarter. Him open, Kez McCorvey at the 40, and McCorvey will take it to the 42-yard line.
Another late flag coming from the referee, and I believe it's going to be holding on Florida State, and it was really a late flag.
Holding called against the Seminoles, and while we got a moment, Jonathan Harris suffered a concussion. Suffered a concussion on that last play. He will not return.
Ron, the only criticism I have of these officials tonight is Bobby Bowden's getting into their ear. Slow. Everything is slow. I mean, it's a delayed flag, and the movement is so slow out there by this crew.
So he erased the play to Kez McCorvey. From the spot of the foul, actually it's going to be inside the 10. It's going to be around the 8.
Put a mark by that play.
Yeah.
That was a turnaround there for Florida State.
Florida State, yeah, they don't come up with a first down on this one and have to give it back to the Hurricanes. You'll have to put an asterisk by. Sacked at the two, and it's Pinard Lang. Second time that they've gotten to him tonight.
Well, when you're backed up in long yardage situation, no one's buying the play fake right now. Jesus Hernandez, number 77, beat by Pinard Lang, number 96.
Going to be picked off by Carlos Jones at the five, and he will score.
Touchdown.
Also, what we need to say about Danny Cannell is if he puts a little bit of bark on the ball, that also could have gone for a distance job. That's how close it was to being a great play for Florida State, and it turns into disaster.
Well, when you get in that situation, you try to throw the fade behind that corner, but Carlos Jones is just able to sink deeper and then make the interception.
It is a 14-point Miami lead. And I don't have to tell you what is on that guy's mind. I think there's a personal challenge going out as far as number 10 is concerned, Derek Brooks, the All-American.
Comes a time when you got to quit talking, though, and you got to play.
Look out at the 30. Gets a block. Takes it out to the 47-yard line.
Special teams have been big tonight. Danny Cannell getting a good pass rush. Who else? 76, Warren Sapp. Threw the ball. Carlos Jones sinking in too deep coverage with the interception and the touchdown.
13 28, 153 yards, three interceptions, and John Stark, the junior out of Nashville, Tennessee, the 6'4 quarterback, will come in and replace Danny Cannell. Stark, just like Cannell, a very rangy young man, 6'4, 215, is a junior and has very good arms. Stoppage in play. They're asking the Miami bench to move back just a little.
The Miami defense has just made plays and turned them into points.
set the screen to the short side of the field, and Crockett is going to be stopped for not much gain by Chad Wilson.
You have turnovers in the game, but the most important thing is to put points off of them. Florida State got two, but only got a field goal. Miami has three, and it's turned it into 21 points.
Clock running down as we're just about at the end of the third quarter. Drills it, and it's incomplete. Messam is the man that he wanted. The one thing that I can see about Stark is he seems to throw in shorter passes with a lot more velocity than Cannell does. And the receivers, we saw one that was tipped in the first half and almost intercepted right after he came in.
He's got a strong arm, and he's an accurate passer.
Going to try to run, and he'll get maybe a half yard. Warren Sapp just introduced himself to the youngster from Nashville. End of the third quarter with our score, Miami 31 and Florida State 17. We'll be right back.
State Farm presents the rules of the game.
We're talking about substitutions. In this play, the player does not get off the field before the snap. What is the penalty?
One fall, we took out our son's favorite sweater, and it didn't fit anymore. I think life insurance is like that. You don't realize how much your life has changed until you take out your policies and sit down with your agent. That's why we have the State Farm Family Insurance Checkup. I can help you see if your coverages are up to date, or if you've outgrown them. Then you make the decision. A policy has to fit. Just like a sweater.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
We're talking about substitutions. In this play, we have a foul, as the player did not get off the field before the snap. Penalize the defense. Too many men on the field.
Rules of the Game has been brought to you by State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Sports writers. Ever wonder how they pick football's national champion? It's a highly scientific process. It's time to settle it on the field. Introducing college football's national championship by Sega Sports. 32 top college teams going head-to-head. No sports riders, just great football action. College football's national championship, only on Sega Genesis.
Taking a look at the weather, we've got a high pressure system
sitting right here,
and that is bringing us
nothing but clear skies and
oh, Mr. Sunshine.
Is it just us, or are weathermen really only guessing?
But hold on,
it's gonna get better.
Clear as a bell,
not a cloud in the sky.
That's why we make the Isuzu Trooper, because life's an adventure. Be prepared.
My prediction, it's gonna rain, trust me.
Isuzu, practically amazing.
Miller Genuine Draft, the cold one.
Oh, you shook me, baby.
For those who've discovered its smooth draft taste, the world is a very cool place. So get out of the old and get into the cold.
WC are scored. We'd like to remind you, piloting the blockbuster video blimp for tonight's event, Terry Dillard of Lake Monroe, Florida. Very great pictures tonight. Didn't look, though, as this night was going to come off this way. We had heavy rain in the Miami area earlier today, but what's turned into a beauty. And if you're a Miami Hurricane fan with 15 minutes showing on the clock, you think that it's even prettier right now.
And they got to be aware of a fake here if you're a Miami on defense.
Very high, good coverage kick. Fair catch is called and made at the 4-yard line. A look at Danny Cannell. This game is a long way from over, but a 14-point lead. But you know what, Mike? The point has been made that for first-time quarterbacks in this this game, it's never been easy. In fact, Charlie Ward didn't win his first time. Gino Toretto did not win his first time as far as first-time quarterbacks in this ballgame. And the list goes on. So it's been a thing where they thrive on people that have not played in this football game
before. Special rivalry. They go after those young quarterbacks.
Gain of two. Mike Tirico, what have you got for us?
Well, Ron, you don't go eight plays and 80 yards very often on Arizona, but Colorado State just did. Anthony Hill to his tight end Justin Schull, two unbeaten teams, and Colorado State scores first.
14-point lead for the Hurricanes of Miami. Casey Weldon is another guy that you can add to that list. That the first time he played against Miami, didn't win the football game. Danielle Ferguson, as a flag comes in, takes it to the 20-yard line.
As Ferguson carried 3 yards.
And of course, as far as Florida State is concerned, you got to go back to 1984 since they have won at this arena. Costa, 15 of 27, 158 yards. He has the one interception. He threw one last year, and Mike had put him on the bench, and he didn't come back until the Georgia Southern game this year. Right now, though, his situation is very different as Gino Toretto looks on from the sideline with his ball club with a 14-point lead.
Ron, you got to admire Frank Costo. He didn't quit. He didn't transfer. He stayed around here, and he knew he'd get a shot at spring ball. He got that shot. Now he's trying to make the most of it.
And he knows that a quick mistake against this defense and the Noles would be right back in it. Draw play to Ferguson. The ball is loose, and that's what I'm talking about right there. It looks as though Florida State has recovered at the 15-yard line. They have. Eric Smith. Darryl Bush took it away.
Darryl Bush, the middle linebacker, made the play. The 4-0 student, players call him Butkus. Just a fake, like it's going to be a pass. There's the strip. Darryl Bush, number 44, big turnover. You were just talking about it. Now, the Miami defense, again, with Warren Sapp leading them on the field. They've been able to hold them to just the field goal on these turnovers. Let's see what Florida State can get now.
Snap, Rock Preston, and he'll take it to the 10-yard line. Sapp got just enough of it.
You talk about players of the game. Now, there's a lot of guys that can be the player of the game. If that play was looking like it was going to be a real big play, and Warren Sapp just was able to get his hand and make the tackle. The great ones find a way to make plays.
Pressure, hit from behind, and he's sacked at the 17 by Kenny Holmes.
This has been the story of the evening for Florida State. They get a turnover, and then all of a sudden, Greg McMackin and the defensive coordinator in this Miami defense says, you're not getting in the end zone. Good pressure again by the Miami front. Kenny Holmes, number 90. Got to take advantage of this third down play.
Third down. The line to make is the 5 of Miami. Drills it. It is incomplete. Almost intercepted by Malcolm Pearson. Pearson is pleading. He got one back in the first half. In fact, the first turnover of the evening is Pinnell threw an interception on the opening drive.
This is vintage Miami defense tonight.
Pinnell will come in to hold. And this ball will be placed down at the 24-yard line. So Bentley with a 34-yard attempt right in the middle. He nails it. So we'll take a break. 12-14 left in the ball game. And our new score, Miami 31 and Florida State 20.
Chrysler Concord's dramatic styling, engineered quality, and cab-forward design have so impressed car buyers that after its first year, Concord has retained more of its value than any car in its class. Knowing that, Concord owners may want to take steps to protect their investment. Chrysler Concord, a valuable expression, a form following function.
Every day in 34 countries and in over 300 cities around the world, Delta Airlines helps people get down to business. Every 17 seconds, Delta has a flight taking off to the world of facts and figures, buying and selling, budgets and bottom lines. Job is done. We have just as many flights to bring you back to the world of mommies and daddies, husbands and wives, boyfriends, girlfriends, and best friends. Delta Airlines.
ESPN's presentation of Saturday Night CFA is brought to you by Chrysler Plymouth and your local Chrysler Plymouth dealers. Well, Warren Sapp right there, that picture has a lot of words. Mike, in just a moment after the kickoff here, I got a stat for you on the defense of Miami. And what they do on Thursday is that, in a way, prepares them for a situation like they had just now with the turnover. But first of all, the kickoff, and the Seminoles got three. They would love to have had seven. And it's going to be Germany at the goal line. Oh, does he get mauled? Will not make it close to the 20. The story is that on Thursdays, the number one offense goes out for a two-minute drill. They're taking it around their own 30-yard line, and they work against the number one defense. One of the players told me the length of time that Dennis Erickson has been here, that only once that he knew of, and maybe twice, that the number one offense scored a touchdown in that two-minute drill against the number one defense. That's the kind of pride that they put into it, and he said, it helps us when we get into emergency situations. I think that'd be called emergency a moment ago.
Well, they really only have had four bad minutes of football, and they gave up 21 points, but the defense didn't give up the 21 points. They gave up seven against Washington, but a four-minute stretch, they just fell apart.
Great defensive play by Derrick Brooks, and he's the man on the sideline that was trying to fire him up a moment ago, and then he goes on the field and does his talking. That's going to be dropped for a loss, and it'll be second down and about 13 yards for the first.
He's doing it by example now on the football field. He knows the clock's against him. Just reading the pulling guard, was able to take on number 61, Jaina, made the play. They've got to keep trying to force turnovers. Miami's going to try to use clock. They're going to try to get the ball back.
Ball is tipped. It was caught anyway by German. Almost got by the tackler. And he's going to take it just shy of the 20. And Costa very slow in getting up.
He was hit by Peter Bowler, number 58. Just when he threw the football. A lot of pressure on that play.
Frank turned to his teammate and said, I'm okay, but that shot on the side of his headgear speaks volumes.
Here's the pressure that's going to come. It's by Roy, number 98, hitting Frank Costa just before he threw the football. Mickey Andrews trying to move this defense around, trying to make plays.
Got him again. This is incredible. This is six times that Florida State has gone off sides, and the cadence, something is just driving him wacky tonight.
Well, what makes Mickey Andrews mad is that Caden shouldn't draw you off. Ball movement is what you go on, and that's what he's telling his defensive lineman. You go when the ball moves. You constantly tell your defensive lineman to look in at the football. Can't let a quarterback draw you off. Tyrant Marion, number 86.
Looks as though that with his shoulder pads moved a little more, but it was a heavy on the second count, and that's when the jump came. Larry Jones comes in as the lone setback. Third down, and they need the 26. Screen to the near side. Tellison. A.C. Tellison tackled by Fuller, and now there are flags from everywhere. 18-yard gain.
Call's going to be on number 66.
Simonette.
Simonette. Pleading his case on the sideline, but they're marking it off.
So the first down was picked up, then the illegal use, the illegal block. So it is a first down. And the ball will be scrimmaged from the 29-yard line. Simonette is out. Curlin Blaze comes in replacing him, number 79. Counteraction. Larry Jones into the secondary, and he's going to have a Miami first down.
When you run the counter play, you're able to pick up everything in the wash. Defensive linemen going into gaps. Everything, when you seal everything down, Miami's had success against Florida State with the counter. You'll see the counter play start to the right. Now both the guard and tackle pull from the backside. Everything is sealed off inside. Ricky Perry, 73, with a big block. First down, and the clock becomes the enemy of the Seminoles.
Under 10 minutes left in the ballgame. 11-point lead for Miami. Jones short yardage this time, but if you're Miami, the two things that you want to happen. You want the clock to continue to run, and you don't ever have to punt again tonight. Although they did have a successful execution of the long snap on the last one.
There's a third thing, too. Hold on to the football.
Hold on to the football, yeah. Bobby Bowden pacing on the sideline. And with the great success that Bobby has had in his career, this is one football team. He's 33% against Miami. Locks the pass. He's got one-on-one coverage. Knocked away at the very last minute by Byron Capers.
Florida State had everybody inside. Eight-man front inside left. Byron Capers, number 23, against Chris T. Jones on the outside. A one-on-one pass. Good coverage by number 23, Ryan Capers. Another look at it. Chris Jones just can't bring it in.
This is incredible. They have jumped again. But Ferguson is off and running down the sideline, and he's finally going to be caught by Todd Rebo. But they got him to jump for a seventh time. While we're sorting it out, here are a couple of injury reports. German, left eye bruise, he may return. And Stewart has been taken for x-rays to a local hospital. 25 yards on the running play by Danielle Ferguson.
Ron, if this ball game holds with the 31-20 lead and Miami wins this football game, you talk about a happy guy that maybe wants to turn on the radio or read the Miami paper tomorrow. Frank Costa will be enjoying the radio and the TV and the newspapers around here for a while, at least till next Saturday. This is a guy that just hung in there and just refused to give in, and this really came back well.
Jones up the middle this time as Miami gives a little 1-2 punch. They bring in the larger Jones, who's 240, taking out Ferguson, who's 195. Brooks on the start.
Frank Costa tonight, 18 for 30, 179 yards, seven penalties, where his cadence has had an effect on the defensive line. You don't know how many plays he's checked at the line of scrimmage in the running game. He's had a good evening here against the Seminole defense.
And Danny Cannell, conversely, situation that three interceptions, one that went for a touchdown that were just devastating to this Seminole football team. They still got 7.5 minutes to rectify it as the pitch to the sideline, and Ferguson never could turn the corner. Clifton Abraham got out there and strung out the play.
Remember, coming into the game, they've only given up 77 yards a game rushing to the opponent. Tonight, Miami has controlled this football game with the running game, 180 yards. Big statistic in this game tonight.
Costa over the middle. It is tipped and intercepted by Florida State. It's Derek Brooks. Gets the blockers in front, and they will take it all the way to the 46-yard line.
Robert Hammond, number 35, with the deflection. Derek Brooks, who's just turning it on here in the second half, with the interception. And Dennis Erickson, that's the one thing. Talk about turnovers. You don't want to give him the football back. Derek Brooks, the linebacker, reads pass. Now he's out in coverage against Tucker, number 81. Ball's tipped by Robert Hammond, 35. Derek Brooks picks it off and now shows he's a pretty good athlete running the football. But now the biggest problem for Florida State, the Miami defense is back on the field.
Jones starts. Deep set in the pocket. Zings it, almost intercepted by Ray Lewis. Oh, my goodness.
In a game of errors tonight. Big errors.
I want it
John
bad.
Starr,
it ain't
away with one.
It's not over.
Derek says it's not over. And that's very true with 7:04 left. There's lots and lots of time. But the Noles are running out a series of downs, so they got to make something happen right here. More than a three-pointer. Ball is loose.
Well, this defense from Miami, Greg McMackin, the defensive coordinator, has to be pleased with the effort of the defense tonight.
Miami football. Pat Riley makes the recovery, and it was Lang who upset the cart.
Just took too long to develop.
That's one of the things, the wind up and the big step to throw the ball. You can't do that against the defense this quick.
Took too long. Now he starts to leave the pocket. Kennard Lang, number 96, with the hit. And now if you're Dennis Erickson, you figure you're going to put the ball in the tailback's hands. Three plays, run some clock here. 6:50, let's run the clock and keep this Florida State defense on the field.
Yeah. field. 8 for the game. Larry Jones. He'll slide off the tackle spot to the 43. James Roberson takes his feet out from under him, and the clock is now at 6:40 and running.
A lot of mistakes tonight, Ron, but a hard-played football game. The effort by both teams been outstanding tonight. Really effort on both sidelines. And there's the key of the night right there, that unit, the defensive unit of Miami.
Ball to Jones, won't make it to the 40-yard line, and it'll be third down and about 6. Darryl Bush is there to make the hit for the Seminoles. Looking for a sideline, and we had a flag route being run by his receiver. So here comes that very evil word for Miami tonight: punt.
Ron, you talked at the open about Miami needed to win this football game to stay in any kind of hunt for the national titles. A lot of undefeated ball clubs out there, they have the one loss, but a loss tonight would have taken them out of everything.
Yeah, that's it would have. Jeffrey Taylor handling the long snap.
And 11 people after this punt.
He got away a really good kick, and it goes out of bounds. I don't believe it. At the 1 yard line. Mike Prissett. So let's take a break. 5:13 left in the ball game, and the Hurricanes by 11.
About 65 miles south of the nearest stoplight, and 2 miles up in the Rocky Mountain sky, you'll find Skier's Heaven, also known as Telluride Ski Mountain, where the skiing's perfect and the views are even better. And whether you're going to extremes or just going for a lesson, don't go without your Visa card, because at Telluride Ski Mountain, they'll let you take the plunge, but they won't take American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
Hi, may I help you?
Yeah, I need some shorts to play basketball.
Indoor or outdoor?
Outdoor.
Full court or half court?
Half, I guess.
Pick up our plan. Shirts or skins?
Excuse me?
Day or night, home or away, team or one-on-one?
Is activewear becoming too specialized for you? Try Discus Athletic. Heavyweight sweats and tees. The activewear that's right for however you play. Discus Athletic. The way America plays.
Horse or pig? After Automobile Magazine named Plymouth Neon Automobile of the Year, there just isn't a lot left to say.
Saturday at 6:30, Alabama's Crimson Tide roll over the Volunteers of Tennessee. And at 9:30, the Colorado Buffaloes take on Oklahoma.
31-20, 5 minutes and 13 seconds left in time of possession tonight. This says a lot. Miami 32 minutes and 10 seconds. Florida State 21 minutes.
The running game, the difference.
Zings the pass out, complete at the 10, and he'll take it up to the 11-yard line. Melvin Pearson. I beg your pardon.
show you again, Florida State has given up 184 yards tonight. The Miami defense, only 40 yards rushing to Florida State tonight.
You can see just how close he came to picking up the first down. Mike Adamly, let's check with you real quick.
Well, you know, Hurricane Streaknicks were really upset when the 58-game run went by the boards against Washington. Not to worry, if Miami hangs on tonight, they will have won their 40th consecutive game, rushing for 150 yards or more, and their 24th consecutive night game at the Orange Bowl.
Well, Stark got stepped on by one of his linemen, almost fumbled the football. And instead of having second down and inches, now they got third down. And let's see, the officials are going to place this just across the five-yard line. So about 5.5 yards. With the pressure, and of course the other danger on a play like that, if you get called for offensive holding, that's a safety, my friend.
He may have intentionally ground this football, but he got rid of it, and that's the key move. Just threw it away. Clay Shriver, number 53, was beaten.
Timeout called by Florida State with 4:12 left in the ball game. We'll take it with him. 31-20, Miami.
Just think, if you were to call 1-800-741-5353 right now, you can order 26 weeks of home delivery of the Sunday Sentinel for just $26. That's a savings of 50 cents a copy, or a total of $13. It's packed with great stuff, like TV time, sports, arts and entertainment, money-saving coupons, you name it. How nice it will be to wake up Sunday morning and find it delivered right to your home. That's 26 weeks for just $26. It pays to read the Sentinel, and you can count on that.
If I was calling plays for the competition, I'd be pretty worried about now.
Ford Windstar is the new standard in minivans. It's the best. The Windstar will carry 7 people plus a whole lot of cargo. Now that's something. Windstar is the only minivan to meet all federal passenger car safety standards.
How can you beat that?
And I'll tell you this. Your local Southern Ford dealer will make sure the deal is going to be right.
What a bunch of great guys.
His Moody Nocturnals of London.
Garrow, you Premi. Cookie Gilchrist. Abe Gibran.
Teddy Roosevelt's foreign policy was...
The running shoot. The wishbone. Crazy Legs Hirsch.
The button hook.
Norm Boulash.
The Providence Steamrollers.
Final question. The poetry composed by medieval knights.
Ken Ohio. Shoot.
What is John Reagan's haircut?
We have a tie?
Yeah!
They do know football. ESPN semi-winning pregame show NFL game day tomorrow at noon.
31-20, and although it's fourth down, Florida State with that little time left, 4 minutes and 12 seconds, and they will go for it. Pressure, throws it, incomplete to Warwick Dillon. Kenny Holmes was just all over.
It.
John Stark never had a shot. Kenny Holmes, number 90, forced the incompletion. Play busted from the start. Beat the block of the offensive tackle. Miami football.
Larry Jones is the lone setback. And he'll get the handoff and probably another and another if he stays in the football game. As the clock is about to go under 4 minutes. We talk so much about the quarterbacks in this one tonight. Here are the comparisons on this evening's ball game. Danny Cannell, 13 of 28, 153 yards, intercepted three times. One of those went for a touchdown. And for Frank Costa, 18 of 32, 177 yards, no touchdowns, two interceptions. Jones at the two-yard line. Henry Crockett, number 45, wraps him up. Continues to run. 254, now 253. Miami probably had just as soon take all four downs to score the touchdown. Or just use four downs to burn clock. Jones hit in the backfield as Brooks knifes through and there is a flag down.
I think the motion man turned up too soon for Miami. Saeed Tucker.
So very quickly, you see Pruitt coming out and also Mike Crissy. Crissy is the holder. And this one is going to be placed down at the 11, so a 21-yard attempt for the Hurricanes to try to go back on top by 14 points.
There, the assistant coach in charge of special teams. He made the adjustment at halftime he needed to make. Put a new long snapper in, but they also blocked very well with slot people and the personal protector. Jeffrey Taylor came in number 59. So you look for adjustments at halftime. They solved the problem they had. Came out in the second half, and again, credit special teams, credit the defense, and credit the running game.
And you can bet Babe Arnold there, Arnie, as he is called, was really working on that gum in the first half because they had some extreme problems. But they found an answer and overcame the bit. But at a time, as Coach Bowden said in his interview when he came back out in the second half, he said, we had the momentum and we let them take it away from us. 14-point game, 34 to 20.
The key play when you go back to plays was the interception when they had the 14-7 lead, had a chance to go in, put some more points on the board, and then the interception by C.J. Richardson really kind of sealed the first half. And the defense of Miami, led by Warren Sapp, just when the ball was turned over, they just would not allow Florida State to score.
This is Rock Preston. Well, he's whacked from behind. Will not get to the 25-yard line.
Look at Florida State's remaining schedule. They got Clemson, who was thumped today. Duke having a surprising season at Georgia Tech. Then the big game, Notre Dame, of course, coming off the loss today. And then the last one, November 26th, against Florida, and then NC State the week before. So still a very tough schedule for Bobby Bowden's football team. And Florida just keeps rolling on.
Mike, can they win the national championship with one loss?
I think they can. I think there's going to be about five or six undefeated teams still around, the Arizona, Penn State. You got Florida and some others. But one loss with these two teams, if they get the right draw in the bowl, would have a shot.
Dad Busby in the quarterback, and he throws the screen pass out to Crockett. And Zach is going to take it up just shy of the 30th. We're about to go under 2 minutes left in the ballgame. Coming up immediately following the ball game, the Residence Inn College Football Scoreboard. Flags are down everywhere. Busby trying to get out of harm's way, which has been a difficult task here tonight.
When we're coming to the ball game, you and I were talking about the pressure on Dennis Erickson here in Miami because of the winning streak and all the different things that have happened here. But you talk about a guy took over a program. He's kept it. They continue to win. And when we were talking about the streak the other day, the players said, hey, we're not bad. We're 56-1. They didn't want to lose that ball game. Four bad minutes of football. But Dennis Erickson has been criticized also, along with his quarterback. And again, you sometimes the real unrealistic goals that everyone puts on you. I mean, he has done a fine coaching job here.
You know, Mike, the programs, the Oklahomas, the Alabamas, the SCs, we're talking about programs that have been good over a long period of time, but they don't win every year. They have their dry spells. I mean, no one's able to do that. And the interesting thing is they did win 9 last year. I know they got thumped in the bowl game, but how many other teams in America won 9 football games?
And they caught an Arizona team last year that was hot at the end of the season.
Yeah, they really were. Well, Busby was very calm. He knew that whistle was going to come or he was going to lose his head.
I really like that Busby. I watched him practice last year. He came out in Rob Hollis' game out of high school. That Busby is a third-team quarterback. Mark Richt, the quarterback coach, says Cannell, Stark, that Busby, all excellent quarterbacks in our system.
Turns the corner, still on his feet at the 30, just short of the first down. Finally a smile from Dennis Erickson. He got wet and he doesn't care. He says, do it to me again.
They've regained the edge here at their home ballpark.
And a timeout has been called by Florida State. Tonight's Visa players of the game are for Florida State. In fact, both are defensive players. It is Derek Alexander, 4 tackles, 1 pass breakup. And for Miami, not going to be surprised at this one. Warren Sapp, he was just everywhere tonight. 8 tackles, quarterback sack and a half, 2.5 pressures. And as a part of their continuing effort to further the development of amateur athletics, Visa is proud to donate $1,000 to each of these universities and $1,000 to the U.S. Olympic team on behalf of these athletes.
Well, Cortez Kennedy's probably watching this game tonight. Russell, Maryland. I mean, these are the same type of players. And, of course, Warren Sapp, a lot of people compare him to Jerome Brown, who went on to the Eagles and when he was playing here at Miami. So that's pretty good company for Warren Sapp to be in.
Derek Alexander looking at the tape on his right hand. The biggest pain, though, is in his heart because they're going to lose to the team that they just don't like to lose to. It's on the ground, a fumble, and Miami has recovered with 17 seconds left, and it's Kenny Holmes. And he's another one that he may not have gotten the player of the game, but Mike Holmes has been extremely effective tonight. In college football scoreboard coming up immediately following this ball game. All the scores and highlights from today's action. Also, we'll be back here for a post-game report. Mike Adamley, Ron Franklin, same part.